Welcome, welcome, bienvenidos. It is Collider Live. It is Thursday. I am Darina. Very tired, but very happy to be here always with you guys because you guys are the best. And joining me today, we got a crazy show. Mark Riley, producer extraordinaire.
Hi, thank you, Darina. Good to be sitting across from you. Tired as well.
Very tired.
When is this week over?
Hopefully soon. But John Rocha.
What's up, everybody?
Always a pleasure.
It's over soon. We get a massive break, and we can all relax, but it's been fun this week shoving all these things in, and I'm happy to be back on Collider Live.
I like shoving things, too.
Hey,
joining us.
I don't know what Roka did, but I'm doing it, too.
One of my favorite wangers ever.
Your favorite?
Same. No.
Oh, hola. ¿Cómo estás?
I said one of them.
One of them? Oh,
yes.
Okay. Brian's our favorite, let's be honest.
True. Well, no, I love Cody, too.
No, Cody's my favorite.
Thank you guys for having me.
Thanks for coming.
Yeah.
Yeah, you never on the show.
No, never.
I'm happy to have you.
You guys never invite me to these things.
I don't invite anyone to anything. I'm too busy.
Good.
But if you invite me, I'll come.
Okay.
Also, joining us in the booth, one of my other favorite wingers ever, the man, the myth, the legend, Cody Hall.
Hello.
Hi, Cody. Hi, Cody.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, Daddy.
Hi.
Hi, Daddy Cody.
Daddy Cody.
Alex
How's that going?
Here as well.
Oh my God!
We were getting there.
Did you guys see Alex's mustache?
No.
Is it coming in? Alex got a mustache now.
I gotta zoom in on this. Hold on. Let me get a close up.
Is it coming in again?
He's gonna get so much ass. This is amazing.
Whoa!
Look at it.
Is it beautiful? I'm so sad I haven't seen it yet.
I want him
Alex,
right now.
Alex, come in here. Okay. I want to see it.
Oh, come in here before
come
I
do.
Can we do the Family Guy thing? Have you seen the Family Guy?
No.
Where Peter gets a mustache and everybody in town goes, he's
got
a mustache.
Oh, my God. Look at this.
It looks so good.
I'm so hard right now. Oh, my God. Get out of here before you make me do something
to you. Did you just say, oh, my God, John, when you were talking about your enormous erection the other day?
Oh, let's talk about that.
Yeah,
what?
Sure.
What am
I
surrounded?
I forget what we were talking about. It was about cats. No, I'm kidding.
Right.
We are going to talk about cats, though.
Bingo game going strong.
It is quite
Furries,
the phenomenon.
Gigantic erection.
How's everyone doing today?
Doing pretty good.
Good.
It's Thursday?
It is. I think so.
We almost got Christmas break. That's cool.
I know.
I'm so excited to sit on my couch and not talk to anyone.
Mm-hmm. Right?
I mean, I love you guys, but sometimes you need silence.
Oh, yeah.
Sometimes you need peace.
Mm-hmm. It's like pulling your electric car in and plugging it in to charge. That's what I'm going to do on the couch.
You got an electric car?
Watching. No, I don't.
Oh, okay.
But I just feel that.
I feel
that I need to plug in and recharge on the couch with a lot of movies and a lot of maybe just probably...
Wine. Yeah, that's what you enjoy.
Yeah. Cocaine.
But it's also...
Cocaine would be good.
Don't do those types of drugs.
No.
Do the other ones. The other
ones
good.
Mom.
But no, I think we are all exhausted this week, not just because of Star Wars, not just because of politics, not just because of cats, but it's been a pretty emotional week, you guys.
Yeah?
There's been a lot of stuff going on, right? Are you guys not tired from that? We saw cats and Star Wars the same day. That was
I don't know how you guys did that.
It's very exhausting.
He left.
Mm. I left an hour and 15 minutes into cats.
Yeah. Oh, you didn't stay for the whole thing?
Why?
Why are you so mad at
you?
I'm just asking you the question.
Yeah. You missed out. We will talk about
out?
It a little bit. A little bit.
Yeah, from the reviews I read, I didn't miss out on
I don't
anything.
Know. You missed out on quite the ending with Judi Dench.
Oh, sure.
As a cat looking at the audience.
Into your soul.
Spoilers. Ooh. Yes. And saying that she is a cat, not a dog.
I love you.
You missed it.
You give zero fucks about cats spoilers.
Yeah,
no.
Right.
Just like.
Because it doesn't matter because you should still go see it because it's the craziest thing I've seen in a while.
It's been on stage. Can't be a spoiler if it's been on stage.
That's true.
For five decades.
I've seen cats on stage.
Yeah.
Well, you have not seen this.
Yeah.
You have not seen what Roka and I saw on Tuesday.
You have not seen it.
No, I haven't.
You have not experienced what we experienced.
I'm going to see it. It's my Christmas present
to
my
mother.
Well,
you like musicals, though, right?
I do like good ones.
You just couldn't stand through that one?
I do like good
ones. Did you love The Greatest Showman?
It's a good one. Made $400 million.
I think I watched
Transformers made a lot of money, too, Roka.
It did.
It's not a good movie.
More than Greatest Showman, actually.
More than Greatest Showman,
sure.
It'll make more than Cats, for sure.
The first one, yeah.
Not the other ones?
No, there's some cool action scenes in Revenge of the
Fallen. Do you like the other ones?
I don't like the second one.
Okay, and that's it? You like all the other ones?
I like all the other ones because they're stupid fun.
Well, and that's how I feel about Cats.
Okay.
You know who loves Revenge of the Fallen? Never mind.
Who?
No, keep going.
Damn.
Oh.
Never mind.
You're not going to tell us?
No, I'm not going to tell you.
Okay,
no.
Fine.
You're not going to call him out, are you?
You should do it.
No.
I think you should.
What the fuck?
You
no.
brought it up.
That was a joke.
Oh, okay.
So Skywalker, you guys didn't like it or what? You guys talked about it? What's going on?
We've talked about it.
I am no longer talking about Star Wars. Okay.
I haven't seen it yet. I can't wait.
No, here's the thing. You did see it.
No, I didn't.
You were sitting next to me.
No, that wasn't me.
You were literally sitting next to me at the screening.
Pretty sure
at
that was Cody. I know me and Cody look alike, but
no, you were laughing.
You do not look alike.
You seen one wanger.
Clapping.
No, I was not clapping. Mm-hmm. Cody was crying a lot, though.
I was sneezing. During the last 10 minutes, I could not stop sneezing. No, I apologize.
I was very worried.
You were sniffling the whole time, and I didn't know if you were crying
or
not.
Yeah, I fucking cried. I'm a pussy,
aww,
that's why. I cried in everything.
Good for you. Yeah.
I cried 3 times during Marriage Story.
Well, three
times.
Yeah.
It keeps increasing. The other day it was 2, now it's 3.
Yeah.
By the end of the week, it'll be 5 times that I've cried.
You ever just cry in the shower?
No.
Oh. Yeah, me neither.
Every morning, Christian. Every morning.
But this is part of you. Let me say this. This is part
of. It's a lot cheaper than therapy. That's
this is part of you getting older.
Completely.
This is what happens to Latinos as they get older. The bitterness just kind of recedes, and then the emotion starts to overcome.
John, I've been crying for like over 20 years.
Well, you're going to cry more, Christian.
Yeah.
Get ready to get older and cry more, because that's just what happens.
I cried leaving cats, that's for sure.
Well done with the sound bites today, Cody. Mm. Well, we got a lot of stuff to talk about, not Star Wars. If you want to check out our Star Wars review, it is up. I would rather you guys not watch it, but if you want to watch it, it's on there. We did an actual non-spoiler review yesterday on Collider Live, and then there's also a spoiler review coming up. I'm not sure when that is
did
with Roka and Riley.
We haven't been tagged on it, so it hasn't dropped.
The spoiler one? That'll probably go up tonight on Thursday. Probably like tonight at 9 or 10.
Okay, cool. Yeah. So then those are the comments I'm much more looking forward to.
Brace, here they come.
Woo. So, but
there's too many of them.
They are, yeah. All the Star Wars references for all the reviews.
Look how big that is.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
look
man.
At the size of that thing.
No.
I got a bad feeling about this.
Luke, at that speed, do you think you'll be able to pull out in time?
This is pod
That's
racing.
That's a good one, Riley. Yippee!
Yeah.
So moving on.
Can I give a spoiler real quick? Not for The Rise of Skywalker, but I'm working on the top 10 Star Wars series.
Oh, good for you!
You know what, Cody? Just because of that, I'm putting you more into it now. Top 10, it starts on the 23rd next week. The fans voted on it. It's a lot of fun. There's like 10 videos. And Darina, there's a thing that you do involving Yippee that you're not going to like that I kept in.
How dare you, Christian?
Too bad.
What you
deal with it?
No, but I did it like where I wasn't having fun.
No, it looked like you're having a lot of fun.
Oh, did you make me look like I like the prequels? Then
yeah, I deepfaked a much bigger smile face on you. we do deepfakes around here. Go check out Frank's new deepfake.
I mean, I actually don't smile. Every time you see me smile, it actually Frank deepfakes my smiling because I can't smile.
He's doing it right now.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm going to laugh like the Joker, and then I'm going to piss off Cody. So moving on, we had a lot of stuff to talk about today, guys. I do want to plug a couple of things really quick before we plug the Wangers short film that everybody should watch.
Yeah, everybody should watch.
Yes, we have a giveaway today in conjunction with Sonic the Hedgehog movie. Everybody who loves that little fast guy, you can get a t-shirt, you can get a sweatshirt, you can get a drawstring bag.
Nice.
And it's all brought to you by Sonic the Movie and Collider. If you follow, the way this works, there's going to be 11 winners. Well done, Cody, with that soundbite. If you follow at Sonic Movie on Twitter and retweet their pinned tweet, you could win all of this cool Sonic swag. So you should go do that because I like Sonic. I think
Love
he's cool.
Sonic. Yeah.
Right?
Yeah,
it's like a Pokemon.
My
thing.
Cousin had a Dreamcast, played Sonic all the time on that. It was
and
great.
It's fun, right? Mm-hmm. It's just an enjoyable video game.
Yeah, I played that game constantly when it came out.
Oh, good!
Thank you,
for
Cody.
You.
Yeah,
I didn't
and then I played
because
the
I
second
have a
one
Sega.
Constantly.
What's Sonic's best friend name?
I don't know.
What is it?
It's the fox guy.
Tails.
Tails.
Come on.
Yeah.
Good job. No, I didn't have a Sega.
No, but you see,
because
I was doing that, I knew it was Tails.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
I didn't have all the consoles. We only had the one.
It's been a while, Christian.
It's been a while.
I'm old and I cry in the shower.
Okay. Yeah. Another thing to plug as well is, hey, Riley.
Mm.
Hey, Roka.
Yes.
I see you're wearing some cool swag.
Yeah, man.
From
Heroes
and Villains. You got your really cool Star Trek bomber jacket here that looks really good on Roka. You got your cool Rogue Squadron Star Wars shirt.
Mm-hmm.
So you can, whether or not you like this new movie, you can wear it and look cool. And today especially, there's actually an 50% off deal on the Ender Collection. So who doesn't like Ewoks? And additionally, if you use our code LIVE10, you get an extra discount. So definitely use our LIVE10 code because we want to beat all the other shows at Collider. Yeah. I love my coworkers, but I am very competitive. So go to Heroes and Villains, or actually heroesvillains.com is where you can do that.
Cool.
So moving on to stuff that matters or does not matter, Riley. What do you got for us today?
Let's talk about The Rise of Skywalker.
No!
No?
I haven't seen it.
No?
No.
He hasn't seen it yet.
You want to talk about Star Wars again? You want to get into it again?
No, I had to mute Twitter.
It's been so exhausting. Like, Mark and I love each other, and we work together all the time, and we work well together, but we are so split on this movie that we're like, I still love you.
I wouldn't say we're like complete. Well, yeah, we are actually pretty split. But no, it's, I don't want to talk about that. We'll talk about that with later. Okay, good.
Thank you,
Donnie. We'll talk about that with box office later. But the Tenet trailer dropped. That was the big news that came today.
Tenet!
I think it's that, you know, Nolan's one of his most anticipated movies. Anytime Nolan has a new movie, it's kind of like everybody stops what they're doing. So Tenet dropped like right before the show. You saw it on Movie Talk.
We did. Perry, did you do Emma, and I did a live trailer reaction, and my live trailer reactions actually consist of just staring at the screen.
That's so cool. It'd be great for the podcast.
I was probably really looked bored, but I was very excited.
Okay.
Who isn't excited about a Christopher Nolan movie?
People that don't like Christopher Nolan.
Who doesn't like him?
Who doesn't?
Just people that don't like Christopher Nolan.
No.
Yeah, because people put Nolan on a pedestal. He's a wonderful filmmaker. I'm a fan of him. Mm-hmm. But people, you know, treat him like he's a god, and he's a human being. He's got flaws.
Well, people treat a lot of people like they're gods, and nobody's a god.
That's true. Jesus. Or Satan's.
True.
Dr. Manhattan's a god.
They treat me like a Satan. Dr. Manhattan is a god, but he's not real, Mark.
What? William H. Bonney, you
Superman's
are not
real, Mark.
A god.
What? So this trailer was really cool.
Who are you talking?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. What did you guys think?
I liked it, but I had shades of Inception, so I'm not 100%
excited.
Did you not like Inception?
I liked Inception, but I already saw Inception.
Okay.
So this whole idea of existing multiple things going different, you know, different ways, going backwards, messing with time, all that stuff is in Inception. So
Dream world it is.
That's what I'm saying.
So I don't know.
But has he been in the dream world? That's the argument at the end of the film. Was he in the dream world the whole damn time?
Right.
Does that thing never falls?
But they're not talking about dreams in this
one. No.
They're talking about afterlife.
Right.
So there's something different there.
It's the idea of reversing time, though.
There's the hook that I didn't know was this movie. And that's, I think you finally get the hook, and it was fascinating to me. Mm-hmm. I don't know if it's, okay, so there was the rumor that it could be in an Inception shared universe kind of way, because at one point there was this font that was kind of like Inception, but after this trailer, I think it's a whole new idea that just has shades of Inception, and I freaking loved it. Whatever that backwards stuff is, whatever's going on in this thing, I'm like, I'm all in. I have no idea what it is, and I kind of want to, this trailer is enough for me. But I know there's going to be like 50 more before this movie comes out, but I really enjoyed it.
I have no idea what this movie's about,
Me neither,
I want to stay blind. I just want to go see it because it looks cool no matter what. Mm. So I'd rather all trailers be like this.
Yeah, no, I think, and the good thing with Nolan's trailers is that they're always very secretive. I saw the teaser trailer in theaters. It was only in theaters.
Oh,
I think,
good
before.
For you.
No, Cody didn't do it, so you don't have the right to do it. Cody, can you please do
Excuse
that?
Excuse me, who's the host?
Oh, thank you very much. I don't know who's the host anymore, Dorina. It's been a minute. I saw it in front of It Chapter 2, which was cool. Like, see, I'm like, oh, what's this? Oh! Okay.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan of the cast. It looks very interesting. I don't know what this time distortion reversal thing is. And I told Cody as soon as I watched the trailer, I was like, is he just going to create his own genre? Is this what's happening right now? Is this going to be like a whole new thing? Because before, I wasn't going to watch it. And Cody was like, nah, it's not that bad. And I was like, is it Inception 2? Is it time travel? And then as soon as he said Afterlife, I was like, nope, I'm done. They're like, no, just keep watching. It's like, all right, fine. So I kept watching it. And it looks cool. No
worries. I echo what you're saying. The cast looks great.
Echo, Trapped. You ever heard Trapped?
No.
Okay. Mm. Look up Trapped. Go ahead. Sorry, continue.
John David Washington. It's good to see him kind of getting more and more opportunities to do these kinds of films and leads.
He was great in Black Klansman.
He was. So, I mean, this is Denzel Washington's son. So all I can think of is the trailer's finishing. Because this is the next level to work with Nolan is like, okay, how far away are we from a Denzel Washington, John David Washington movie? Like,
yes.
How far away are we from
Son?
Father Son.
That'd
could
cool.
even be
oh,
a Nolan time thing between both of them.
Dude.
I don't know.
Oh, spoilers.
What if Denzel shows up in this as the older John David Washington?
That'd
some
be pretty
time
cool.
Thing?
Christian, that was a very impressive scream.
Damn, man.
Thank you very
much. You can sing, huh?
No, my dad can sing. I can't.
I think you can sing.
Maybe. I think we all can sing. You just got to work to it.
Yes, exactly.
Except
you have to
Rebecca
practice.
Rebecca Black.
Yeah.
She can't sing.
But I am very excited about this trailer. I cannot wait to see this movie. I want to know what it's about ever. And I guess they're showing some IMAX sort of prologue before Rise of Skywalker.
Mm-hmm. He's done this before. He did this with Dark Knight, with the opening with the Joker heist. Right. He did it with Dark Knight Rises. I can't remember. Inception he did too.
Yeah.
Part of the dream sequence at the beginning of the movie.
And Dunkirk.
In the
IMAX, they showed
this is his deal.
Dunkirk wasn't a movie, though. That was an experience.
Also an experience and not a movie. Cats. Cody, Alex.
Meow.
You guys excited for Tenet?
Yes.
That was a weird transition.
That was
a transition to go into Cats, but you
I
just
thought
asked
we were doing
Tenet.
Cats.
No.
I was like, oh, but we're still talking about
no,
Cats.
No,
you sure
no.
you're the host?
Oh,
is that how you do things?
This is why I brought him, though. No, this is why I brought him, because when I go on the Wangers,
we just treat each other like shit.
We just always give each other crap. But that's why I love, honestly, out of all the podcasts I do, that is like an actual podcast, the Wangers is my favorite.
All right.
You guys haven't been on it, huh?
No,
they don't.
You guys
they
haven't
won't
been
ask.
Invited. They won't
ask. Brian deals with the booking. Yeah. I just have the studio and Cody's the humor.
So you just blame it on somebody else?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's how we do it.
That's what I do, too.
It's not my fault.
Yeah. So you want to host? You want to sit here? You want to sit here, Chris?
No, that's too much power.
Yeah, you sure?
I don't like that.
You don't like responsibility?
Nah.
Actually, when you're in the host chair, the power is removed. Completely.
I'm like Rose Tico. I talk to pipes all day. I don't talk to humans. You guys are the ones steering the ship.
That's true. You are. Well,
so utilized a little bit better.
Let's not talk about spoilers. But Cody, Alex, I was trying to get them involved as the good host that I try to be and have their opinion on
but
the Christopher Nolan movie.
Your transition. You set up Cats. As if that was the next topic,
yeah,
and I thought you
I
were going to ask.
A cat
I know, I like
and
confusing people.
Okay, yeah. Can we just...
Like, I was ready for that, because that's what I was expecting.
To each his own.
Yeah.
All right, so let's talk about Cats. Cody, what'd you think about Tenet?
My God.
Christian Rubalcaba.
I don't know what you get.
It's that Latino anger that we got in here.
Hey, Roka, let's just go get a breakfast sandwich while they figure this shit out.
No, it's okay.
Cody, I want to know what you think about that.
So Christian's never coming back on this show.
Right.
No, I'm kidding.
This is his first and last.
No, he is. I love Christian. Cody, Alex, do you guys care about Tenet at all?
Yeah.
See? That's what I wanted. That's all I wanted, because Cody always has the best opinions.
Yeah.
See, and you made me wait for that, Christian. That's all I wanted from Cody.
It's all about the buildup. It's not about how it ends. It's the journey to it.
Well, ask your girlfriend and see what's happening. Anyway, that's right.
Holy shit!
Right. This is what happens at the Wangers. You guys should watch the Wangers. Speaking of the Wangers,
Merry Christmas.
Before we talk about the Cats review,
yeah.
Christian,
yeah.
You're here to plug something cool.
I'm here to plug something hopefully cool. Hopefully hopefully people think it's cool.
All your stuff is cool, though.
Dude,
Let's hear about it.
Come on.
Me and Cody, we directed a new short film together. It's called Stage 4. Cody wrote it, and it's coming out this Saturday.
Nice.
And
well done, man.
Very excited. Thank you. Thank you very much. We've been working on it for like 4 months. It's currently on our Patreon right now, so if you guys want to check it out, patreon.com/wangers. It's going to drop this Saturday early in the morning, and hopefully people don't suck. What do you guys think about it?
Yeah, we haven't seen it yet.
When did
you send that to them again?
I believe I sent it to these guys on Monday.
Yeah.
But I sent it to Darina on Saturday.
He did, and it's on my to-do list.
Yeah.
And now I'm going to put it lower. I was going to put it higher because you said there was like cool like homoerotic stuff, but now I'm going to put it lower because you yelled at me today.
It's one of the most challenging shorts I've ever seen.
Okay.
Really?
Yeah.
So when you guys like have
what they tackle, what they explore, and then also what they present for you to deal with as you're watching the short, I'm surprised. Because, I mean, after you see them do the guru one, you're like, oh, these guys are just doing funny stuff. And the pumpkin one was really funny. The Halloween one was incredibly well done.
Pumpkin one?
Yeah.
Pumpkin?
Do you want the compliment or not, Cody?
No,
I'll take it.
We are very confused.
Wait, the shape?
He's talking about
the shape.
The Halloween one.
But the pumpkin is what I focused on in the shape, so
yeah,
I like that. And Grace's hair,
with our friend Grace, because
Grace is amazing.
Also Teddy.
Yeah, and
Teddy's my favorite, actually.
So you go into this, and I'm like, I'm not sure what to expect. And you guys are pushing the boundaries, so respect.
Trying to, yeah.
Can you talk about anything about it at all? About a little bit?
It's not like the thing that we're keeping a secret is just, I mean, you'll see it. Once you see it, you'll be like, oh, okay, cool. It's not like a fan film that we're like surprising anybody. Yeah. Surprise, it's a Friday the 13th, nothing like that. But there's just a certain thing about it that's just really, really cool that we want everyone to be surprised with. But it's about a man named Ethan, who Cody plays. He wakes up from a heavy bender the night before, mm-hmm. To a world rapidly changing around him in horrifying ways.
Ooh, mm-hmm. So it's a horror thriller type.
Horror thriller,
thing.
Yeah. Okay. It's with Cody, Brian, Grace makes a little cameo. Ken plays, and John Cena plays the president. No, and Ken.
John Cena's on all your shorts, right?
He makes a cameo everywhere. Everywhere.
President.
I saw that still of Mr. Napzok as president of the United States, mm-hmm. and I was like, that makes sense to me.
it really does,
yeah. And I would vote for Ken Napzok.
We're on our way there.
Yeah, we are. We can put Ken Napzok.
How did you know
it
was a political thriller?
I am excited to watch it. I'm going to watch it and text Cody and Brian. What a good job they did.
Thank you.
I'm sure you did a good job too, Christian. But I have to say, you guys are very talented. As much as we give each other crap, I love all your shorts.
I think you guys do.
Like, I love the runner. I gave crap to Brian about how he ran, but it was shot really well, and I like the story. These kids are talented. You guys need to support him.
You gave him crap after he had said, "Oh, I was made fun of running my entire life."
I know.
And then she makes fun of him.
Yeah.
No, it was. He told me that after I gave him crap, and then he's like, "That's what I've been made fun of." I was like, "Oh shit, sorry."
He had to go to therapy for that.
Yeah.
Everybody who's friends with me has to go to therapy, Cody. That's just what it is.
You think we'd learn by now?
Let me ask this question.
Oh shit.
Can you cry about being made fun of when you make fun of other people? You kind of lose your right, don't you?
Cody,
Roka has kind of a point.
He's looking at you, Cody.
I'm saying Brian is no slouch to making fun of other people, so to cry about being made fun of kind of loses its weight.
It's like a self-deprecating kind of back and forth, I think.
Hot Cody, take. Should we have Brian call in?
I was just thinking.
Please have him call in.
Well, if you can get him on the line, that would be
great. We have
one
more Latino on the show.
I know. We need more Latinos.
Well, me and Brian are fake Latinos. We're not real Latinos.
Faux Latinos.
Why are you fake, though? I don't think you're fake.
Just move on.
Fautinos.
No. Fautinos. You're of the descendants. Your family is mm-hmm. Mexican, mm-hmm. so you're Latino.
Yeah. Got a little Spanish in there, too.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
Mom's side? I don't know. Okay, I gotta do 23andMe or not. Is that bad?
No.
Yeah, no, you don't want to put your DNA out there. Yeah.
I mean, they already own us.
They do. They're listening to us right now.
Yeah, like if you have an Alexa or a Hey Google at home, you're screwed.
Dude, last night, my Alexa started doing this blue. Does anybody have this? Where all of a sudden.
Can't afford it.
Julie and I. Great, that's fine. Wonderful. I know what I'm getting you for Christmas.
That's fine.
Yeah.
It ain't that.
That's
the blue light.
That's fine that you
no,
can't
No, but
afford.
Does anybody listening right now, watching right now, this blue light started going around. I'm like, what is it doing? Because Julie and I were having a conversation, and
it's
it was almost like
guys.
It was recording, but it was just, there was no prompt. There was no, hey, Alexa. Sorry, everybody at home for turning on her. Yeah, there it is. What is that? I had to unplug it because I was legitimately concerned that somebody was spying on us. I mean, we were talking about wedding planning, so everybody, wonderful.
They probably are. Yeah. I mean, also your phones, like everything that's on our phones, everything we put on here, it's out there.
Hey, Siri.
You just have to deal with it. No, this is not an iPhone.
Oh, hey, Siri. You're one of those. Okay.
Yes, I'm one of the uncool kids.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is it Android?
No, it's a Pixel.
Okay.
But Android operating system. Yeah, but the phone is also.
That's
Pixel.
What my girl has. She won't do it. She won't do an iPhone. She hates iPhones.
I just couldn't do it. I couldn't do the iPhone. Really? I tried years ago. I just couldn't. I'm just not into it. It's not for me.
I tried to go to the Android a few years ago, and I'm like, I can't do this.
Well, because it takes a while to get used to it.
It really does.
Whereas Apple is known for being user-friendly, but the Android system, you can kind of manipulate it to work for you and you can change stuff in the operating system, and that's nice.
Because
I'm a control freak, so you know.
My first smartphone was an Android, and I got really used to it then, and then we just all of a sudden switched to iPhone. I've got no... I actually saw one of the newer ones recently, and I was like, oh, wow, this is really cool. The ones, the edges, it curves over. I was like, oh, this is pretty cool. But
I mean, I don't know.
The technology is where it's at now. They're all good. These phones are all good right
we
now.
All,
sorry.
We all have everything we need on our phones, and that's crazy. Mm-hmm. And we still complain about everything. Mm-hmm. It's pretty dumb.
Yeah.
So speaking of complaining.
Welcome to life.
What else do we got today, Riley? I know we want to review cats, but Roka's probably not going
to
talk about it a
meow.
Lot.
Of course. Let's do it.
Okay, are you ready then?
Of course.
Okay.
What are my ears?
So,
are we going to break though? Or are we going to break soon?
No,
or are we
we're
going
to go to break at 11.
Oh, perfect. Yeah. Let's do it.
It says break at 10:35 right here.
that was a typo.
That was a
speaking
production.
Of typo. You spelled my last name wrong.
Where is it?
We've been friends for
you
how
didn't
long?
Didn't put the
enya on there. Instead of
Rubalcaba. Should have put short. Didn't spell my last name right.
Where's the enya?
I thought for sure.
You guys treat Trisha Helfer like this?
No.
Okay.
But we do have a lot of misspelled names in the green room that we have to fix.
Oh,
so
that's
there's
funny.
That as well.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Welcome to Collider,
I'm just
guys.
Keeping the tradition alive here.
So, Roka, Why did you walk out
that.
Of
yeah, go ahead.
Why did you walk out of Cats?
Oh, I'd hit my wall. Oh, good for me. No, I'd hit my wall. I was like, I'm going to watch at least what I can of memory, and I'll get through Taylor Swift. I was out within the first 10 to 15 minutes of the movie mentally.
Yeah.
Because I went in, you guys talked me into going because I had planned to go, then I wasn't going to go. And then you guys talked me into it, got me a little altered. I went in there, and as I was sitting there, I was like, I am not having a good time. I have no idea what's happening. Mm-hmm. I have no idea. Every cat introduces themselves, and they're all assholes. And I'm like, I don't really give a shit about anybody in this goddamn play.
Is that
and
I
don't know if this is part of the show itself, that all the cats are assholes, and they just... I mean, then I heard from the Universal people before I even went in there that Tom Hooper was still editing this damn thing, which is why he missed the junket. He's still putting fur on cats! And so I'm like, this is nuts. This is nuts all around. So, and it isn't kitschy nuts, which I was hoping for. It was like bad nuts.
So you didn't think it was awesomely bad, because no. I thought it was awesomely
bad.
That's
what I said in my tweet. It's not Showgirls bad.
Right.
It's not like Independence Day Resurgence bad. It's like just bad.
I don't know, man. I think
no
I understand why you left, because it does get a little like slow and boring in the sense that like you don't know what's happening and it's just a bunch of weird looking cats, because that's the thing about the musical Live is that they have makeup on, right? Mm-hmm. And so they just look like people with makeup on. Whereas this movie, it looked like the weirdest version of a video game of the musical Cats.
They CGI and children's faces on mice bodies.
They ended up making oh yeah. They ended up making a creepier movie than
really
Polar
crazy.
Express.
Whoa.
That's how creepy it is.
Agreed. Even the cockroaches have faces.
What?
Uh-huh.
No.
Oh, yeah. I was sitting there. Perry was next to me. Jim Bebeda from IGN was next to me. We could not stop giggling. And also, I was like, what drugs am I on? I felt like a parasite was eating my brain while I was watching this movie. But I couldn't stop watching. Does that mean that's why I stayed till the end? And you missed some stuff there.
Missed.
Like, you didn't see Jennifer Hudson sing Memory, right?
I did see the first part of Jennifer Hudson singing Memory.
Yes.
And then when she got shooed away.
So she was amazing.
Riley
being
a
sassy Mark
just
like, today.
That is Grandpa
I was
Riley.
Doing the,
everyone knows
rock
the song.
Rendition.
Move on.
Wait, you didn't like the cats were assholes?
Wait,
yeah, I didn't
cats
like
are
cats
assholes.
They're not. They're awesome.
Cody, cats are assholes, right?
You're supposed to have a protagonist. No.
See?
No.
Cody's a cat person. It's not
I'm
Alex.
A cat defender.
Alex and your new
Same.
Mustache. Cats are assholes, right?
Yes.
Thank you, Alex.
Christian.
Alex.
Cats, cats
how dare
are
you?
Assholes.
Cats are the best.
No. Cats are assholes.
No.
Cats are the best.
Dogs
Let's
are
cancel
mean.
Cats.
No.
We're canceling cats,
no,
not
we're
the
not.
Movie with the animals
no, the
themselves.
Animals.
Cats
cats
live their
wonderful.
Own lives.
Yeah,
exactly.
They're not attention whores like
yeah,
dogs.
Like
Thank
dogs.
You, Cody.
I'm sorry. Cats aren't insecure and need attention every time.
Well said, Cody.
I think dogs are just so stupid. That's why they want the attention.
That's
cats don't,
why I don't,
cats
like
don't
him
run
much.
At the door when you walk through. They're just like, sup, bitch.
You know who
My
has a great
animal?
I don't
want
to
yeah.
give away the bit, but Matt Nose had a great bit about cats
oh,
in
yeah.
his stand-up. It's
yep.
wonderful. Go see
oh,
Matt Nose
yeah.
stand-up. One of the funniest
yeah.
human beings
he
on the planet.
He is very
yeah.
funny.
Great.
I do really like him. Matt we should have
great.
Him back on the show.
Mm. Or you can download Top 10 every
Oh, there you go. There's that.
Every
so,
Tuesday.
I guess I didn't realize we were going to yell each other about cats versus dogs more than Star Wars stuff.
I love them both, but I respect cats greatly.
I think cats are
animals.
Amazing. Like how they fall and then fall on their 4 feet, that's insane.
I don't want to talk. Fuck, never mind. It's a Star Wars thing. But you got scared at one point and I was laughing because you were covering your fucking eyes, you pansy.
That's not my fault.
It's not my fault.
It's not my, like in the words of Lando.
I don't want to talk about it. Fine.
There was a sort of annoying scene during Star Wars that I'm not going to spoil, but there's some creature involved and I was very uncomfortable.
Oh,
I was
I know
very
what
uncomfortable,
you, yeah,
and Christian was sitting
hysterical.
Next to me, and he laughed
like, what
at me,
the fuck
and
are
I'm
you
good
doing?
For you.
How much drugs is
Because I don't like
you guys,
them.
They don't like each other.
I know.
No, that's just our.
No,
I
he's
know.
Like
Back
my brother.
The banter.
It's fine.
Yes. That's the banter. Yeah, it's all brotherly love.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh,
anyway,
so I got to hear a little banter, a little nonsense.
Thank you for that, Mark.
You're welcome.
Do you know why anything was happening in the movie?
I know only cats. Because I know the actual musical.
See,
because
I don't.
Because otherwise, I have no idea why anyone would know what's happening in that movie.
Thank you.
Yeah, I agree. Because that's because it's not a good movie, but it's an awesomely bad movie, John. If you had stayed, you would have seen Dame Judi Dench in CG ridiculous looking makeup, looking directly at the audience and telling you, "I am not a dog. I am a cat."
Is that what
over and over again. Yeah. Mm. It was
That's some deep themes right there.
Yeah.
So I've seen Cats on stage. Mm-hmm. And this recurring review of that they're assholes.
Yeah.
Like, I've seen that in almost every review.
Oh,
really.
Okay.
That the cats basically one by one, this is what I'm getting from it. One by one they introduce themselves and then they're just assholes. Mm. And I'm just trying to wrap my head around that, because in the play it's just like, you know, a lot of dancing and singing, and I don't get the fact that they're assholes. So
my
I'm
favorite,
trying to figure
though,
it out.
Were you there when they all started saying hi to each other as cats and basically started, like, come here. Come closer to me, John.
Oh, shit. Here
come
we go.
They started
visual
doing
aid.
This.
You going to lick her?
Yeah.
Audio-only listeners, Darina just did some very naughty things right now.
Yeah, that's...
Jesus. I can't even describe it. It's disgusting.
I am on the naughty list every year.
Children watch this show.
Wow. I am on that. I really hope they don't.
What?
I really hope children don't watch this
even
show.
Taylor Swift wasn't.
Tay-Tay?
Tay-Tay is in
Taylor
the movie.
Swift was not.
She is in the movie.
She was. It was.
And she looked very happy to be there.
I thought it was going to be a show-stopping number. And it
really, though?
Really
but you
wasn't.
Actually had high expectations for this movie.
Well, because the talent. Are you kidding me? Like, Ian McKellen, Judi Dench. The lead, McNamara, she's an incredible, incredibly accomplished ballet dancer.
Yes.
And then, exactly. And then
Idris.
And then Idris Elba. Yeah,
my boy Idris.
James
Judi
Corden.
Dench, yes.
There's all these people that are involved in
I
this.
I do have to
and
say.
And Taylor, who's a good singer, clearly.
Emma Fyfe, I was with her on Movie Talk this morning with her and Perry, and she brought up a good point that Ian McKellen was the only one that I think knew what movie he was in.
Yes.
Because he was like, I'm just going to start meowing because this movie's ridiculous. And everyone else was actually trying to do a really, really serious good job. And I felt bad for
it all was of like, them. It was like watching a bad black box production with your friends who just finished their first level of acting.
Ooh,
and
yikes.
They're in
I've got
there,
plenty of those.
And they're in there. And, they've learned this is the first stage of their acting training is to play an animal. So they're just going to do that for an hour and a half.
And then they have the cat, the cat tail
that
was all
CG
that looked creepy the entire time. I just didn't know I would be as petrified of a movie other than Polar Express.
Please tell me there was like a furball comedy scene. Like
yes.
Oh, yes.
I'm sure.
Oh, you will get those.
Furball.
All the cat jokes, look with a cat dragged in, all that's in there.
Oh,
yeah,
that's good.
Which is why I recommend this movie.
It's Raining Cats and Dogs?
I don't know if that was said.
No, okay, no. Maybe it's not as good.
Catnip, I'm sure.
So you guys are not going to see it?
Probably not.
No?
I'm not a musical guy.
Alex is a musical guy. Are you going to see it, Alex?
Yeah, I'm into it.
Yes.
That Dorian?
Exactly.
You got so close right into like, yeah, I'm into it.
Was that Dorian?
Have
that
you
Alex?
Heard Alex's Dorian impression?
Apparently it's really good.
Yeah, do it, Alex.
What's up, guys? It's your boy, Alex.
That's pretty good.
That's pretty good, right?
What's up, Dorian?
What's up, guys? It's your boy, Alex.
What's up, guys? It's your boy, Dorian.
Yo, what's up? It's your boy, Dorian here.
What's up, guys? It's your boy, Dorian.
It's not bad. It's not bad, Christian.
Right. I can't tell.
It's so wonderful how consistent he is. Every
really
show
is.
That he's on is, yo, what's up? It's your boy, Dorian here.
Yeah.
Every single show. He's great.
Dorian is the best. He doesn't want to come on in as much, but we're going to convince him next year. What else do we got today?
No,
Mark?
I want to hear it. I want to talk about cats.
You
want to
keep talking about cats?
Show.
I'm down.
No,
let's
just,
do
I
it.
Just, the more
are
you guys
not
going
to watch the movie?
No, I have to go see it on
right?
Christmas Day with my mother. That's
yay.
The whole point.
You're going to be she talking about cats forever.
She wants, yeah, she oh, wants to see, the, like,
good
this
one.
Is her Star Wars.
Good one.
My mother's Star Wars is Cats.
Mm. And now
she's
you
like,
have to see it.
When she heard that, when she saw the trailer, she's like, did you know there was a Cats movie? I'm like, yeah, Mom, I did. And she's like, we're going for Christmas.
And yes,
like,
you are. Yes, I can't wait. I can't wait for you to tell me what you think.
I want
to
see the comments of the tax. What's the Cats fandom like? Are there toxic Cats fans?
Probably not like Star Wars.
Give
or
it time.
That'd
be
or
funny.
Superhero.
Give it time.
I want to go
I'm sure
YouTube
they'll figure comments. Something.
I think this is going to be one of those weird cult phenomenon things that people are going to just watch as a midnight movie.
I think
similar
it's not
to like The Room or all of those awesomely bad movies.
I don't know. It feels that the reviews are feeling otherwise.
Because,
I mean, some of the reviews would be like if.
But
like,
it's like 20% on Rotten Tomatoes. I mean, it's bad.
Correct.
Yes.
But I'm not
17%.
Hearing.
17% on Rotten Tomatoes.
17?
Go up.
17.
Go up.
Have you guys talked about 1917?
No, I know that it's. I hear it's the
not,
best
can you
movie
not
of the
talk
year.
About 1917?
I'm not sure.
Is there an embargo
if
for that?
It's
no.
Been, it's
out.
Been out.
Yeah,
is it out?
No, it's not out yet.
Not out.
Coming soon, so I don't know if you can talk about it. Coming actually Christmas Day as well. That's really the movie everyone should be
you
watching
can talk
on
about
Christmas
it.
Day.
Should be 100%.
There's no embargo on it or anything?
I'm not sure. So I don't know. Alex, can you
I mean,
please
reviews
find
are out?
Out.
The reviews are out.
There you go.
Look, they're right there.
Can you talk
oh,
about it,
well,
Christian?
Shit. No, I can't talk about it. I haven't seen it.
Oh.
No, I'm kidding. I saw it. It's fucking great!
Yeah, I hear it's... Yep. Incredible.
It's one of the fucking coolest things I've ever seen in my entire life.
Mm-hmm. I'm so excited.
It's
Is that your guys' top movie now of the year?
It's one of the best ones.
It's my
number
one for sure.
It's your number one.
By miles.
I was sitting next to Cody and I could just feel Cody's energy.
I was sneezing. I was just sneezing during it.
I have to see it.
So was it basically the way it's shot that was so impressive?
Yeah, but the story as well is very intriguing. No, it's not just a gimmick movie.
Okay.
The fact that it is what it is just is cherry on top.
Yeah. Okay.
What is the Trump thing you do?
Oh, I'm a Latino, bro. We do our hands. I don't know. Fucking just let me be, bro.
Easy now.
Let me be, bro.
Let me be, bro.
Let me be, bro.
See, you guys should handle this. Actually, I have a dance off as cat. Yes, Mark?
You haven't seen it yet? 1917?
No, because I had a day where I watched Star Wars and Cats on the same day, and they got to see 1917.
What a loser. You haven't seen a movie before us. What a freaking loser.
Would you guys put it at your number one movie of the year? Is that where we're talking? Yeah.
Yes.
No, not yet. I'm still, I've got some.
He just said that.
It's number one by miles.
Oh, I missed that. Okay.
Yes. That's your number one. He's top, sort of.
It's a great film.
Right.
But as a movie, I don't know.
What's your
top
favorite?
Right now?
It's up there. Okay. It's one of my faves.
I don't know. I really liked, what's the, what's her name? Sam Weaving movie. Is her name Sam Weaving?
Oh, Ready or Not.
Ready or Not.
Samara Weaving.
That
need to
great.
Catch up on
it's
that.
Really great.
Yeah, Marriage Story is really great.
Marriage Story.
You cried too.
There's a couple.
Oh, Jesus. Did I ever.
Rise of Skywalker's there. You guys want to talk about that?
No.
Yeah.
Okay.
Parasite? Yeah, I finally saw it.
Yeah, Parasite's dope as fuck.
Isn't it so good?
It's up there. It might be my favorite movie of the year. It's between right now Jojo Rabbit, Parasite, and Joker, to be honest with you.
Those are on my top 10 for sure.
Those are in my top 5 for sure. I'm just going with my
top. Oh, and Glass.
Glass.
You
good
love
man.
Glass? Are you serious?
Are you serious?
Was that this year?
Come on.
That was this year. That was January.
It was in January. It's
I really liked Glass.
Year,
Glass stuck with me for a long time.
You can see our review. Jeff Snyder did a spoiler and we did a spoiler review.
Great
see?
Plug.
Good job, John.
Almost a year ago.
Anything else you want to plug for people to seek out from last year?
See, I actually
so
watched
January
that review.
2019, if you go back on Collider Video.
I like to lean into the jokes.
It's good.
This is why we bring you on the show, though.
Thank you. I wish JoJo had been in my top 5. I tried really hard to get it in there, but I couldn't put
you
it
You didn't
in.
Love it?
I liked she it. Said. I liked okay. it a lot.
Oh, man. I it made me cry, and I rarely cry in movies.
Right.
Jojo Rabbit was something else. I think everyone should be actually forced to watch that movie.
Forced?
Yes.
Forced?
Oh. Not forced, but, you know, I
That's
think everyone
Latino
should
thing
be
that comes
encouraged.
Out, that third world country.
It's incredible.
Love forcing
dictator
things,
thing.
Yes, it does.
It's within us all.
It really is. That's why we move our hands a lot.
That's why we scare them.
That's truly. Well, I'm happy you finally saw Parasite, Mark, because I've been telling everybody to see that. I think it's one of the best movies, not just of the year, but of the decade. I'm obsessed with it.
It's incredible.
It's so great.
We were screaming. We were screaming at the TV. There's moments in that movie where it just keeps going. Mm-hmm. That escalation of just like,
you're just stressed
what the
out.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
It was so great. I love movies that do that.
How was that?
What the fuck? Oh. What the fuck?
Good job, Mark. Yeah.
Might
Thank
need
you.
A third time.
Mm. Oh,
clean.
What the fuck? Did
you
get
go.
It, Cody?
I don't know if I got a clean. Maybe a fourth.
Okay. Oh my god.
Okay, ready?
Oh my.
Wait, everybody, quiet. What the fuck? Thank you.
Well done,
Thank
Cody.
You for pulling my favorite soundbite.
It really is. Other than the scream. Mm. So we actually are going to have Ken Napzok join us at 11 for those that love Mr.
Ken is great.
Yes.
I just did a Napzok Files with him last night. So you guys
did
check
you
that
guys?
Out.
Oh,
yeah.
Nice.
What did you guys talk about?
He watched it. So we talked about stage 4 just us traveling together and a bunch of other us being grumpy and stuff. It was really fun.
Oh, yeah. You guys had a bad traveling experience.
We had a bad traveling experience. We talked about that.
Is that when you went to
D.C.?
For Ellis's special?
Mm-hmm.
Or not
special, not
special
but
his
one of his shows.
Stand-up, Okay, cool.
So was it an emergency landing or something that like...
So it was basically... Yes, they didn't want to call it that because they didn't want to freak anybody out.
Right.
Basically what happened was the pilots were smelling a weird odor, and so they were forced to put oxygen masks on, and so they told us...
You guys were too?
Not us, not it, just the pilots.
Jesus Christ.
Because they said they've experienced... Well, they didn't say this. I found out after the fact that they've experienced this thing. I think it was American Airlines, so just, you know, watch out. But don't tweet at publicly airlines. It's dumb. Sorry, really.
Yeah,
but,
no, until they
good
fuck
plug.
With you.
But, good plug. Yeah, check out American Airlines, YouTube.com. I found out after the fact that crew members on American Airlines have experienced this weird odor, and they passed out from it. So I think the pilots sought this out ahead of time. So we made a landing in Arizona, and we're like, look, they shut off like all the interior power. It was very scary. I don't like flying as is, so it scared the fuck out of me.
Yeah.
I was really scared. So then we made an emergency landing in,
do you smell something?
Yeah, yeah. That's weird. We were talking about that last night. Yeah.
I was like, it's just a weird odor. So confused.
Yeah, right.
But we talked about how people around us were just being the absolute worst. And it was like, we're alive. We're here. The pilots made a quick decision as opposed to, you know what, I'm feeling lucky today. Let's make it all the way.
No, we can power through this.
Were people just complaining in general? Or
because this was at like 2 or 3 in the morning to a closed airport.
Right.
Oh. And so we had connecting flights, and we knew we were going to miss it, so we were dealing with that. And so everybody was just like hammering at the only two people that were working there that night, just being fucking assholes.
Why do people do that? I don't understand. Like, that's the least helpful thing to do in a situation like that, where you just got to play your part. Mm-hmm. And you've got to be part of the team so you all survive together and listen to people that know what they're doing.
Because they have a voice and they want to use that voice. That's what's so good about this country, damn it.
Then just go on Twitter. Just yell on Twitter.
They do it there too. I guarantee they were tweeting at American Airlines that same night. And me and Ken are just sitting there like, hey, yeah, this is a fucked up situation, but we're both alive. We're here now. And then we ended up booking a flight straight to D.C. from Phoenix. So it was fine. You're fine.
So you were fine.
Yeah,
you, and fine. You didn't overreact at all.
No, me and Ken were like just like chilling there like people watching. Some guy was just like, that's not what you said earlier.
No.
That is not what you said earlier.
No.
Give me a flyer. I don't know.
Jesus.
So.
I don't. Jesus. I mean, granted, we do complain a lot on these shows about movies, so we're pretty stupid too.
Mm-hmm.
But I just think that in situations like that, you should just be a little bit respectful.
Yeah. Just put things in perspective. Yeah, and just take a step back.
Just be nicer to each other.
Hold that energy when you want to cry in a bathtub or something like
that. Exactly.
You know? That's what I do.
That's good advice.
You should start an Instagram where you just
crying
like,
in
take
the bathtub?
Selfies and you're just crying in the shower.
That's pretty funny.
You should do it.
Like that and patent that. Cody, patent that.
Patenting.
Can you get that on the screen?
That was my
Cody, can you look at my Twitter real quick?
Patent pending.
Are you? What's on your Twitter?
Nothing.
Then why do you want to?
Oh, pull up your Twitter.
No, it was a joke.
Oh, I didn't get it.
I think Cody may have gotten it.
I got it.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Cody got it.
Great.
He likes to make jokes for me and only me, and definitely not you guys, and definitely not the audience either.
Nope.
It just made me laugh.
No.
Off camera.
I
and
do
off
that.
Mic.
I do that all the time to Cody, and it's the most awkward thing I'm sure for him.
We do have the typo on the screen here, though.
We do. Thank
that's
you.
The,
that's great.
That's great.
Christian Rubalcaba instead of Rubalcaba.
Pretty close though.
Rubalcaba.
Actually, no, it's not close at all.
It's not close
two
at all.
Words.
Nah, it's okay.
It's misspelled in the Google search results then. Because I
fucking
legit,
did you have to Google his name?
Yeah, I can't. I'm so bad at spelling.
Why didn't you just
I am. I'm just bad at spelling. I could have, but he's usually busy. So I just went, hey, let's go. Oh, Google put it up. That looks right to me.
It's on my
copy
Slack.
Paste. I could have done
you
that too.
Just slacked him
there
too.
Are so many things I could have done to spell your name correctly.
It's also
correctly.
Not fair because I know everyone's names here for the amount of videos I've had to work on and put in Twitter handles and stuff. I know everyone's names.
That's true. You're
so lucky. Abdul Mateen II. I know how to spell that now.
You're so
nice.
Lucky. You see, but then you know stuff more than us. So.
Yeah, but then I forget a day later or something like
well,
that.
Well, and
so
as you get
great.
Older, you're going to cry more and also
and
forget
die.
More stuff.
Oh, yes, that too.
Yes.
Yeah, look at me.
Wait
this
die.
Is your future.
Mm-hmm.
Sad, crying.
White.
Spelling errors and white.
What is
and white. What happens to all of us? We just
why is everybody so sad today? What the fuck?
I think we're all just
pick it up. White. It's Christmas. Pick it up.
Oh, Christmas is. I'm like,
so,
I'm like Phoebe Cates from Gremlins
you're so
on
Latino
Christmas.
Right now.
I know. Pick it up. Come on. Be happy.
Wait, do you think we're too emo
it's
today?
Esmeralda, bring the turkey.
What?
Do you think we're too
turkey.
Emo today?
You have turkey on Christmas?
Emo?
Yeah.
Emo?
Do you think we're too sad
yes.
today?
Yes.
Why?
People don't want to pay attention to sad stuff. Pick it up.
Okay.
Pick it up.
Okay.
Make some jokes.
Jesus, and? John.
Suck it up. No, I know.
I'm not a fan of the suck it up.
God.
Not a fan of that.
You're not a fan of sucking it up
God,
in general
I've,
or sucking?
No. You know, here's the thing about sucking. Cody knows all about this.
Anyway,
he was sneezing.
So we got a lot of stuff for you guys
still
today.
To talk about. Correct.
Obviously, as you can see, we're a very professional team here, and this is what Collider Live is all about: is that everything happens and anything can happen. We are going to play a cool John Williams game later. Mm-hmm. I think it's cool because I love scores.
Yeah.
And I'm pretty excited about that. We all brought our top 10 John Williams scores.
Yep.
Right to the table because there was an article about that on Collider.com.
Fun discussion. See if they got it right.
Exactly.
On Collider.com. Yeah, there is a correct way rank John Williams scores.
Well, now, we will fight about that later. We also have, as I mentioned, Ken Napzok coming on the show. And if you, I'm sure you've noticed already that the live chat is turned off because people can be kind of dick sometimes, not the good kind of dick, and they spoil stuff. Yeah. So it's going to be off. It'll be back tomorrow. But once people get the opportunity to watch the space movie tonight. What else do we got today, Mark?
Well, speaking of space movies, Star Wars tracking right now for a $450 million global opening.
Wow.
So, wow.
That is so low.
So, no.
So much lower than The Last Jedi.
Is
Star Wars done?
Nope. The Star Wars Last Jedi opened with about $450 million worldwide.
Wow, that's on par.
That's on par. Wow. Thank you for the can you please just be my right man, right hand color
can
commentator?
You just show
of course it's color commentating.
Can you just show up to all our episodes and do that?
Yeah.
Just like basically, just you can be
are you with
Riley's
hype
man.
He's not coming
when
on
he reads
the show
the news.
Again.
No,
ever.
No, I'm
ever.
Done. You don't want him on the show?
Getting I'm fired today.
No, and so Force Awakens, to give you some context, did open at $528.9 million worldwide for the very first Star Wars movie to come back in under the Disney regime. So here we are. It's kind of on track. Mm. I didn't know if what you guys thought, if some of this divisiveness, some of these very negative reviews. It is getting pretty, you know, the reviews aren't that great. But do you think that it was going to affect this, or is this on track in your opinion?
I mean, I think it's as when it's a big franchise movie, like a Star Wars or like a superhero movie, it's going to do well no matter what. If it's a popular thing like Star Wars, like, you know, Batman, all of those things, I think it's probably not going to do as well as the other ones because of the negative reviews. But most people outside of our space don't even look at reviews. They're just like, it's a Star Wars movie. I'm going to go see it with my family because it comes out in December.
Yeah. It's an event.
Yeah.
It's Star Wars. Yeah. Bring the family. I think it's going to do fine.
So we can whine about it as much as we want, but people are still going
to
see it.
People have already bought their tickets,
too,
right?
Yeah.
So, like, I mean, they could just choose not to go, but the purchase is already there.
Right. What they're banking on is, like, the people coming back to it over and over and
over.
Over and over.
Yeah, that's true.
That's the thing.
Because I saw Force Awakens 7 times in theaters.
Wow.
Nice, dude.
Oh, good for you.
You liked
it a lot of money. Liked it. I saw Last Jedi, I think, 4 times.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Do you like all of them?
Yeah. Yeah, I do. Yeah.
I figured.
Is that okay?
Of course it is.
Is that okay?
No.
You can like whatever
you want,
Christian.
Can I be a dog person and like The Last Jedi at the same time?
Only if you respect cats.
Fuck.
Yeah.
Fine.
John.
Yeah.
What do you think?
It's interesting. 450. I think it's going to come in lower than that. I think the reviews are going
to. I feel like it is too.
It feels a little. It's got a little Solo vibe to it in terms of people's reaction to it. And people are kind of upset and not liking it. And then the fandom is lashing back at people not liking it. So we're back in this pit again.
Oh, God.
Sadly so.
Good Lord, dude. I liked it,
pit?
And people are lashing out at me
for liking it. That's what I'm saying. Both sides are getting lashed.
It doesn't matter. We're either haters or shills, basically.
Both the cats
There's
and
no
the dog
area.
People are getting destroyed.
I've seen Disney execs pay you guys before.
Yeah.
I've seen that. I have it on video.
Do you have it on video?
In Mickey Mouse cookies.
Do you have my money? Because I haven't seen it yet.
Yeah.
I take a percentage out of it. Yeah.
Is that what happened?
So you take the 100% because I haven't seen it yet?
Dude, $5 is $5.
I will take it.
You're just going to spend this in all the wrong places. I'll keep it for you. But no, I think if 450, if it gets that great, then it's fine. It's untouchable, like you said, and it can move on and blah, blah, blah. But I just feel like the bad reviews are going to stop. And yes, a lot of people don't go see it. A lot of people don't read the reviews and go see it.
Mm-hmm.
But those are the people they want to come back to see it over and over again. And they may not, because they may not like it and agree with some of these reviewers without knowing those reviews anyway. So that's what I think might affect it overall.
Right. I mean, I think it's not because it's a fine movie to me.
Sure.
It's not this, like, you know, amazing movie. It's not a horrible movie. I think people are just going to be like, oh, that was fun. I enjoyed it.
Mm-hmm.
Babu Freak is, like, the coolest little Muppet ever. Mm-hmm. So I that's what I want to see again.
Not the rest of it, but just that. I sold my ticket back tonight. I was going to go, like I said before, with 106 of my friends.
You sold it back.
I sold it back.
Because I thought it was going to be, like, an event to go with 100 and something people. Yeah. Damn, John, what made
you
decide
that?
Uh-huh.
Fuck, man.
Yep.
Christian's like, how do you have
who
so many?
I
only
is
have
not
one.
Who I am outside of here.
Cody and I are barely friends.
I sold it back because I was like, I saw it. I'm good. I'm good with seeing it.
So are you? Because here's how I feel. We have
maybe a month from now. I'll see it again.
We have our screening tomorrow, right?
Mm-hmm. You have a screening.
No. Well, but are you guys going?
No, I'm gonna go to Knives Out or something.
Wow.
So you're not watching this movie again.
I'm coming to the party.
So you're not watching this movie again?
Not for a while.
That's how I feel.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm. I was going to watch it again tomorrow.
I enjoyed what I enjoyed from the movie.
Exactly.
And listen, there's a lot to enjoy in this movie.
Yes.
But what I didn't like really kind of affected my overall enjoyment of the film.
Okay.
So I don't need to go see it again.
Right.
In a month from now, maybe I'll
That's
go.
How I feel as well.
Yeah.
Okay.
You're seeing it tomorrow.
Yeah, I'm seeing it. I
you
can't
too?
Wait.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I can't
Amber
wait to see
hasn't
it again.
Seen it, so she wants
oh,
to.
Yeah,
that's
Julie
cool.
hasn't seen it.
She's a big fan of Kylo Ren.
I'm a big fan of Amber. Cody, Alex, are you seeing it tomorrow again?
Yeah, I'll be there.
Nice.
Alex? I'm seeing it tonight at the Cinerama Dome, and I'm very curious to see how that audience reacts to it, because they can be very vocal about what they love or
hey,
hate movies.
How many times is that for you?
At the Dome?
No, not at the Dome overall.
Jesus.
At the Dome, you dipshit.
That'll be my second time. Thank you again, Roka, for taking me. That's
right. You know what this fool did? I got him in. He goes, hey, I'm not going to sit with you. I'll let you know if I'm going to sit with you or not. And then he doesn't let me know.
Guess who he sits next to?
Yeah.
Us.
The imagine yeah. How many times I'm going to let Alex be my plus one for a future
thing. Oh, Alex, you messed up.
To be
but
fair,
what about that mustache, though?
You had a pretty hard rule, like, I'll sit in the balcony.
Yeah.
You're just like, nope, I sit true. In the balcony. There's
but
no
then,
conversation.
But then they shut off the balcony. So I had to sit down there anyway with the plebes.
Did they really?
Yeah, they shut off the balcony.
Oh, I didn't
Why
know
didn't
that?
You sit next to us?
So what I don't know. I didn't know where you guys didn't tell me you were sitting. So
well,
I didn't
know. You said you were going to be upstairs.
Only saving the entire
Otherwise, you would have saved That's you a fair. Seat.
But I found a good seat. I had an aisle seat that was kind of jutted out, so no heads were in my way. So I could watch the movie.
Same.
And Winston and Jay and I sat next to each other, but we put our popcorn next to each chair, so we had that space. And we claim that the person was at the bathroom or getting food. Or
you guys are
so we had
that makes so much sense that you, Winston, and Jay all did that same thing because you guys are. I love all of you, but you are like hombres frágiles.
Yes,
the fragile man that need their space.
We need their space.
Their,
we're not fragile.
You are the worst audience member I've ever. That's ridiculous.
Well,
dude. Come on.
You know what's sad is that we were able to do that and people weren't waiting outside, so it wasn't a full theater.
All right. Well,
yeah. That's so sad. Star Wars is dead.
I mean, I don't want to go that
Star
far.
Wars is dead.
Well, here, I'll throw the last thing to you.
Everything you love is dead!
Wow. It's true. Wow.
We brought the goth kid today.
I'll throw this out there. It is tracking right now stateside. There, it indicates in pre-sales that it could do $200 million.
Right.
But tracking is at $175
million. Right.
That's so that... Isn't it weird we're at a place now where under $200 million is like, well, it failed.
It's yeah, like, it's like, I want to fail like that.
Yeah.
Give me $100 million and call me a failure.
$175 would put Rise of Skywalker, I think it would be like, uh-oh.
Yeah.
It uh-oh. But just at least for, I mean, it's going to make its money back.
What would happen
the
if
saga's
it goes,
over.
If it does solo
oh, I don't numbers. Even, I was going to say, don't even say it. I don't even want to think about it.
Yeah.
I just don't want to think about it.
Well, Solo didn't
That's
even
insane.
Hit $100 million opening.
Yeah, I know.
Is that right? It was like 80 something.
Yeah.
So if it didn't open to $100 million, then there's a gigantic conversation.
Oh my God!
God forbid.
You sit in the room. You play the game.
You gotta play the game, Christian.
You gotta
playing the game.
Okay.
I'm playing the game.
This is one of my favorite episodes we've done.
I'm so happy, Cody.
Good. Thank you, Cody.
Is it because of Christian?
Yeah, it's funny.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
I'm laughing.
Okay, good.
As long as Cody's laughing, it's all
that's
I want.
That's my only reason.
That's
basically.
Really, that's
it's
really
my only
all I
reason
care about.
To do the show is to make Cody laugh.
It's very true.
Yeah, and Alex, obviously. Not John,
Alex,
because
dude,
John hates him
fucks,
now.
Dude.
It really does.
Yeah,
mustache is so fucking awesome,
really
man.
Does.
Thank you.
I can't wait.
I can't get over that.
I can't wait to shave Alex's mustache off his face for not sitting next to me.
Holy crap.
Okay. Hold
I
still,
wanna
Alex.
I want to see that video.
Hold still, Alex.
Damn.
John Rocco was me too for shaving a mustache.
I was canceled?
Oh, it's only because I called you fragile. Jesus, man.
I'm fragile.
I'll show you fragile.
Yes, you are. Mm-hmm. But you admit it.
Yeah, I'm fragile and a failure.
You're all none of you are failures, but you're all very fragile, which is fine.
I think everybody in this space is very, very fragile.
Mostly men.
I would agree.
We're men.
We're
fragile.
Women are fragile, but men are very fragile.
Men are the
fragile.
Fucking worst. Can we talk about men for a second?
Yeah, let's do it.
Can we
because
manspread
we are,
on
yeah.
men being the worst?
Did you say manspread or
yeah,
mansplain?
Yeah, well, manspread against man. Well, manspread and then splain.
Okay.
Against the men.
Okay.
I like
but
it.
But why against? It's not a bad thing to be fragile.
No,
you just got to admit you're fragile and work on your fragility. That's all.
Fragility?
Are you my? Yeah.
Is that a word?
I don't think one
don't know.
Space
fragilidad.
In a theater
How do you
is...
say fragilidad in English?
Fragilidad.
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 Is it fragility?
Mm-hmm. Fragility?
I think you're trying to say fertility.
No.
Fragility.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's Italian.
It's a good word.
So you guys have to work on your fragility.
Wait
if
a minute,
that's
wait
a
minute,
word.
Wait a minute. It's not fragile to want to have a little bit of space in the theater. That's not fragile.
Yes, it is.
You're being fragile right
yes,
now.
It
fragile.
Is. Yes, it is, because you need your space. And
you offended, bro?
What?
Are you mad, bro?
But, like, look, the fact
that's
that
not my Star Wars.
Yeah, anybody that has, we all have our particularness about certain things right. as to where we sit and, like,
everyone's
how the lighting is. And, like, so. But,
I call it OCD. I don't call it fragility.
But it is a sort of fragile thing to be like, oh, if I don't get this and this doesn't please me, then I'm going to be a little whiny little bitch.
No, but I wasn't. If someone had sat next to me and it was full, I wouldn't have complained about it.
But would you have enjoyed the movie less?
No. I just would have been like, okay, it's not going to happen.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I roll with a lot because a lot of bullshit happens in life. So you just got to roll
really
with most
does.
Of it. You got to roll with I hate those people, too, that go up to the poor receptionists at the airport. And all they're like, oh my God, crap, I got to deal with this today. Mm-hmm. And there's human beings trying to. Now, if they're being unusually rude, they deserve all your vitriol. Mm-hmm. But if they're like just trying to help you and you're being a super jerk like Steve Martin in Planes, Trains, and Automobiles, then you deserve to get fucked. And so
I think the most snobby I'll be is in movie theaters when people are disrupting, like either talking back to the movie.
Oh, that's
or
bad.
How's that not being fragile?
That's not. I don't think that's fragile.
I think that fragility is because.
Again, is this a word?
Yes, I don't know. Look, at, Alex, can you all please right, look?
Can
it
we look
up?
At the hold Twitter? On. Can we look at the pull up the Twitter, please?
I know
thank
it's
you.
A sting song. I know it's a sting song.
Fragility.
No, that's fragile. Yeah. Is it just
fragility?
Fragile.
Is
fuck yeah,
a noun. The quality of being easily broken or damaged.
Ooh,
yeah.
So isn't fragile. That all of us?
Yeah. Easily broken. I think all of us are not easily broken.
I think but
we
all very
do
sensitive.
We wouldn't do what we're doing if we were easily broken.
Yeah, we would give up.
Let we me, need little sessions of crying to like, you know, make sure it doesn't all come apart. Yeah. Right? So you just cry a little bit every
like,
day.
Do you guys like
in the
look
shower?
At the, do you guys like look at the comments? Like do you say like I don't look at the comments but you secretly
no,
go
No, I love
do look
looking
at
the comments, because I actually
no,
I,
really
I love replying at the troll comments. Like when somebody's
yeah, but you're
like
feeding them. I do the same thing.
No,
sometimes
but I don't do it in a mean way. Like if somebody's like, oh, Darina hates this Star Wars movie. She's trash. And I'll be like, I actually didn't really hate that movie, but I am definitely trash. And then they reply with I don't think you're trash, like they freak out, but because I didn't, because I agree with them,
because they don't think that you read it and then they realize you're a human being.
Yeah, exactly.
It's like, yeah, no,
I did that. I'm doing a Rise of Skywalker thing for my Patreon page, and somebody just started yelling at me but it was a point. And I'm like, and like he's actually yelling at me on a Patreon post, and so I finally just respond and go, so you don't want to be a part of my Patreon? And he deleted the stuff. He just didn't even come back. He just deleted it all.
Do you think that's like, just word vomit from commenters, because they're either dealing with something else in our lives that like people are just like, oh, I'm going to yell at this person I don't know for this other crap I'm not dealing with.
Very reactionary too. Yeah. Like it could be. I've seen things like that where people are commenting and saying the most nasty things, and then you respond to that and they say, I'm sorry, I was having a bad day.
Yeah.
This and this happened. And it's just like I was taking out some anger. It's like, it's fine. We're human beings.
Yeah.
But, you know, also know that there are repercussions to that, because if we do read these things, that could affect a lot of people, because, you know, not just people in this space, but everyone is fragile and everybody has a breaking point.
Yeah.
So you got to get to a point just like, don't be a fucking dick. If you like, because I hear people talk about all the time how much they hate Twitter. And but that's the thing. I fucking love Twitter.
Me too.
I love it. But if people are saying I hate Twitter, this is the worst, then
just get the fuck off of it.
Right. Who cares about your fucking brand or what you have to fucking promote? Right. Just get the fuck off of it and stop complaining.
I don't disagree with
that.
I love Twitter.
I love Twitter.
Everything about it should be really good. There is a lot of toxic things on it. That's for sure. But that's the
but
same thing with everything.
But there's toxic things on everywhere. Say,
you
it's
can
just
avoid
a matter what
the
you
toxicity
choose.
If you want
yes,
to avoid
exactly.
the toxicity.
Toxicity, great song by System of a Down.
There's a way to do that.
Spotify.com.
But I agree with you. I think people who complain about something and stay on something is like you're trying to have it both ways. And it frustrates the hell out of me. I've never hated Twitter, nor will I hate Twitter. And I've even stopped calling people trolls. I call them either fanatics or fans. And that way I don't even feed the trolls by calling them trolls. To me, it's fanatics or fans.
Fanatics is actually a good word for that. Because
is that
it is,
a word, though?
It is.
Oh, okay.
Fanatics is a word.
So is fragility.
Fragility.
So they're fragile fanatics, basically, is what we're calling them.
That's a good band name. Fragility fanatics.
And we've all been there. We're all fragile fanatics at some point because we rant about stupid shit. But we also try not to offend other people for disagreeing with us. That's what. And I've done it before. I used to be an asshole know-it-all and tell people, like, if you don't like the movie I like, you're an idiot, and that's really dumb. So I'm glad I'm not like that anymore. I still got a lot of stuff to work on. Before we do that, though, because we are close to having to have a break. And Christian loves
10:35 already.
Christian loves my segue. So
cats.
Yes, exactly. So you actually have to go, Christian. Huh?
Yeah, I have more work.
He actually has to work.
Love to stay for 2 hours, but I got to do some.
But it was a pleasure
coming,
having
dude.
You.
Thank you guys so
appreciate
much.
It.
As much as I love fighting with you on air, I love
it's a lot
you.
Of fun.
Please come back.
Yeah.
Everybody, watch Stage 4.
Yeah. Check out John Rocha and Jeff Snyder's Glass review earlier this January. You can find that on the Collider Videos channel right now.
Also
subscribe.
It out.
Great review. Well, I think we'll put a link down below in the description.
And check out Christian this weekend on Mailbag. Collider
I'll be on Saturday's Mailbag.
That's a real plug. He will be on Saturday's Mailbag.
Amateur
Hour
Films this Saturday, Stage 4. It's a brand new short film for myself, Cody, and Brian Perez. Alex Marzonia did the fucking score, and he killed it!
Because Alex Marzonia is very
wonderful
talented.
Musician.
We are going to take a break. Thank you for being here, Christian. When we come back, Ken Napzok will be joining us. We're going to talk John Williams, and we're going to do a bunch of other nerdy things. We're going to take your calls as well. So go to the bathroom, drink some water. We'll be back.
Yabba.
What a twist!
God damn it, shut the fuck up!
Hey,
yeah, let's develop some inside jokes. I wanna know you, man. Wanna make you smile. Wanna be your sunshine. You're upset, you need somebody to confide in, I'll be there for you. I wanna make you smile, wanna be your sunshine. Maybe I'll just hold you, you know, maybe we just hold each other and then, you know, be okay with the silence and like not feel like somebody has to say something. We'll just like listen to what our bodies tell us to do. Let's take a day trip to Santa Barbara, me and you. Let's hit up some charming shops. Let's buy some antiques. And I'll text you back something witty. Hey, man, I got you an orchid, baby. Like, give you some meaningful compliments. You in Diamond Bar? You want to stop by? Stop by, man.
Your boy Dorian. What's up, guys? What's up, guys? What's up, guys? Your boy Dorian.
David Johnson.
Welcome back to Collider Live. We have had a very chaotic first hour, but very happy to have one of the extra wanger on our show. And now joining us to replace Christian Rubalcava is my favorite David Harbour light, Ken Napzok.
I can never replace Christian Rubalcava.
Christian Rubalcava.
Hey, everybody.
How
Why
you doing,
are you
man?
Eating pretzels?
They're so good. Have one.
No, I know they're good.
It sounds great into the microphone.
Why are you doing that?
They're
you got
so
a Starfleet
good.
You got the boring science version of the cool thing up there. And then, you know?
That was pretty good, Ken.
What does your shirt say?
King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard.
Are we on air?
Oh, we're on air, Toxic
oh
Fandom.
Oh, my God.
You like music?
We're on air, Toxic Fandom Defender.
That
we're totally on
one.
Air.
Hey, Ken, you like rock? You got to check out King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard. They're amazing.
Okay. That rhymes.
They're really great, especially like live. One of the Wizard. Best bands that we've had in modern times. They're
okay.
amazing.
Okay.
I think you would very much enjoy them. Did you get your Liz Fair tickets, by the way?
I did.
Did you get me one?
No. They're very expensive.
But I would have paid you back.
No, I know. It's about capital.
Yeah.
What you have at the time.
Yes. I understand.
Yeah, I know
I
that
understand.
All too well.
This is exactly what I did. Click. How much? Nope. Basically.
I should have done that.
How yeah. much are they?
I did not. I paid close to $1,000 on credit card. I don't have them.
How
I don't
many
have
did you
the
buy?
Money. Those.
Two.
You
two.
Paid almost
$1,000
for
two tickets?
Did you get good seats?
Atlantis yes. is still pulling.
Where
Atlantis
are you?
Is still pulling.
I am in
I
like
fucking love Atlantis,
I am like the third section back. So there's like the
yeah,
rich
like
people.
Like the garden seats.
Like
yeah,
yeah, but it's like
rich?
Behind that.
Like, you're like
it's like rich. You pretending to be rich? That's me.
Okay. Yeah. Pretending to be rich, but we just spent all our money from like
yes.
last month that we made.
Yes.
And then the people in the back.
Yeah, I'll be paying interest on it long after the concert's over.
But hey, that's how much we love Liz Fair. And garbage and all those people.
Well, here's, I always say this on my deathbed, which I hope is a long time from now, and I hope I see it coming. Ken, do you have any regrets? No, I paid all my credit card bills on time.
Yeah,
no, I'm gonna be like, I got to see Lattice Garbage
exactly.
and Liz Fair at the Hollywood Bowl.
Correct,
yeah,
yes. Have you seen them before?
I have seen Liz Fair a lot. I don't
that's
think
that's the
I,
one I haven't seen, that's why I'm
yeah,
glad to see her.
Garbage in the Atlantis, I don't think I've seen live.
I saw Garbage a few years ago, and I was very, very happy to see Shirley
Stupid
Manson in front of my
girl.
Face. It's so good, man.
Do you like her Bond song?
Yeah.
I like
that
Bond song.
I love that
Bond
song. Are you kidding?
Songs, and
it's a great...
Mm-hmm. And it's an excellent music video as well.
Yeah, it's a great music
video. Yeah,
she's
it's
sexy
all sci-fi.
As hell in that music video.
Which Bond is it again?
The World
Is
Not
Enough.
Not enough.
Yeah.
That
Got
one.
Which
yeah,
is quietly
really
one
good.
Of my favorite Dalton Bonds. I mean, Brosnan.
Pierce Brosnan, yeah.
Ken, what's the venue for this concert?
Hollywood Bowl.
Is it Hollywood
Bowl?
Okay.
Oh.
Wow.
Okay, well, yeah. I'm going to try to go.
You can't even get those $6 ones in the back. They don't put them available.
No.
There's a
Jeez, damn it. I'm going to have to spend money. Maybe I'll get it as a Christmas present for myself.
There you go.
Yeah. But anyways, as we're talking about music, and we all love music, and we all love scores, and it's great that Ken's joining us because he loves John Williams like we do. Correct?
Yeah.
Yes.
I've seen him in concert at the Hollywood Bowl.
Me too.
The best.
10 times in a row. That's kind of
crazy.
You've
been 10 times
once,
in a row?
Once,
or 12 or something
you
like that.
You couldn't say this to him when he was walking by you at Rise of Skywalker?
No, I met him at the Last Jedi premiere.
I know, but you still could have said, hey,
no,
great to see you
I
again,
already
John.
Bothered him once at the Last Jedi premiere, and
you
I blacked out. I don't want to talk to them anymore. I don't like talking to famous people.
Really?
I just don't.
They're just people.
I know, but I don't want to bother them when they're at those things and they're being bothered by everyone else.
Okay.
So, I'm
with you.
I understand. I was
I'm
at the Last Jedi premiere, and you stuck us in the VIP section. Elson, I didn't want to go, and then you tricked us into coming in. It was great. Frank Oz. I stared at Frank Oz, and I was about ready to step towards him because I wanted to just thank him for Dirty Rotten Scoundrels.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
And
good man.
I think we would have had a good conversation because he was being very nice. And someone like cut in front of me like a 501st Cleveland shirt on and was like, bah, 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 bah. I'm just like, get out of here. And I was like, I lost my opportunity.
Yeah, that's what happened. Yeah. The only reason I did it with, I went up to John Williams with Wendy is because I think I was talking to Nathan, and he's like, he's going to die one day. I'm like, I should.
That is what?
It's
but
really
what? He's
this
old,
is,
though.
Can you stop that?
I get that.
But
you
we all
stop
gonna
that.
Die, though.
No.
We're all gonna,
shut up, everybody.
We're all going to be dead in a few years.
Darina, I understand. This is
the
second time you've said this on fucking on air. We know
Collider
this.
Dead.
We don't
Collider
talk
dead.
About it, though. We can't, the man is a genius legend.
And you
I
think he's not going to die?
It. I get it.
Correct.
I get it.
He is going to live forever.
David Bowie then.
No, he didn't.
Oh, wake up, me heroes.
Anyway. Anyway, speaking
just
of death,
just for one day.
Oh, it's a good song, man. It's a really good song. So, John Williams, he's lovely.
Still
he's
alive.
The best. He's still alive. Hopefully for longer. Hopefully he outlives us all. He is a genius. We are here to talk about the top 10 John Williams scores.
Let's do it.
Who is the writer of the article on Collider.com that people can check out?
That would be Adam Chitwood.
Chitwood!
Love Adam's stuff on .com. The top 10 John Williams scores of all time, which I love. I love these lists for Collider. Great discussion that we can do. John Williams, of course, being my number one, so I have a lot of thoughts on this list. Should we go in and read it right now and then compare our list, or how would you want to do this?
So I think we're going to do the same thing we did with our best movies of the decade list, where we just kind of go around and sort of rank our favorite John Williams
scores. Cody should have the and tell us what Adam had, right?
Correct.
Isn't that what he did?
Yeah, have it up, John.
He has it up. Great.
Cody's doing his job, John.
Don't you talk down to me, Cody.
I'm just saying.
Why are you being so fragile?
Men are fragile, right, Ken?
Alex is going to be fragile after I get done with this Collider Live. I'll tell you that right
now. I mean, people are fragile. But men are a little bit more.
Sure.
So you don't think so? I'm asking.
We built the pyramid. We landed on the moon.
Okay.
We built the pyramids.
You're showing your fragility right now.
Yeah. I think your answer is correct. Humans are fragile.
Humans
and
are
have
fragile.
Different moments of strength and different moments of weakness, and that's okay.
It's very political correct.
I
answer,
love Ken Napzok.
No, but it's just because it's a weird. It's a weird.
Agreed.
Fun bit.
Yeah.
But where I'm just like.
Don't get me wrong. You just described sitcoms
just play
the last
fart noise.
No, and I get it's
where
like,
the idiot is the man.
Yeah, no. Every Kevin James are we allowed to say Kevin James on the show?
I don't know.
I think it's a banned word.
But you know, like I get it. Yeah.
Yeah, I mute Kevin James.
Do you think
on
he looks
Twitter.
At Uncut Gems and he goes, "I should have been in that"?
Probably.
Yeah. I'm sure he wants to.
Okay. Yeah, so anyways. Let's start.
We were supposed to make a list. Is that what I'm hearing?
Yes, our producer.
I thought I was just playing the game. I apologize.
Oh,
that's
not
all right.
His fault.
Oh,
I didn't read it right. Yeah.
Oh, you didn't.
That's all right.
That's okay.
I'll come up with
it. We
top
don't
of my
read
head.
Right ever, so it's fine.
No, I'll get IMDb. That's the Internet Movie
Database. Correct.
So as we're celebrating John Williams, let's start with our top 10. So Mark, you go first.
Okay, at number 10, correct?
Yes.
We're gonna go down and then up.
Yes.
Okay. So number 10, I have Saving Private Ryan.
It's a pretty good one.
It's one of the best scores he has. For me, it's not, you know, obviously we'll get to my favorites, but there is something very, very, very powerful about that score. It puts me right back into the movie. I love this score so much. If I'm in a particular mood, I put that score on and just listen to it straight through because it's just, I don't know, I write to it as well.
It's really good.
Because it's just very dramatic.
I mean, he has not made a bad score, that man. My top 10, because I'm going to give Ken a little chance to go through his list, is actually one that I was very impressed by when I first saw it in the theater because it was the first score of John's that I've heard to be pretty different because it was so jazzy, and that's Catch Me If You Can.
Oh, yeah.
I think it's an excellent
one.
Score. I got to see it live at the Bowl.
Good choice.
And the, how do you say flautista in English? Flutist?
Flute?
Yeah. Sure. So the guy was playing the flute. Like, it was really impressive, and it's not something that's super... Exactly. You can sing it. But the arrangements underneath, like instrumental-wise, are crazy.
It's one of the grades, yeah.
What you got, John?
Yeah, my number 10 is Jurassic Park.
Yay!
All right. Yeah,
it made the list.
Speaking of Jurassic Park,
it was close.
Do you know who I saw yesterday?
Who?
Jeff Goldblum.
Nice.
And his
was he in the Rite Aid?
Yeah. No, I saw him at the Rockwell with his band.
Oh,
he was amazing.
That was last night.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, we're gonna go again in January if you guys want to come.
Cool. Yes.
Yes,
please.
But they did play a little Jurassic Park on the saxophone.
Oh, nice. That makes sense.
Have you heard Jeff Goldblum's lyrics to Jurassic Park?
No.
He's like, in Jurassic Park, scary in the dark, better run or you'll be eaten.
Oh.
But he sang it on a talk show, and it was really
so
Jeff
good.
Goldblum-y. It was perfect.
So, cool. Ken, do you have one?
I haven't seen any of these movies.
Okay. So, what's your number 9, Mark?
My number 9 is Harry Potter.
Oh, wait, sorry. Before we go to 9,
no
Cody,
problem.
Are any of those on the list?
We had two winners.
Okay.
We have Catch Me If You Can was on there. And we have Jurassic Park was on.
Ooh. There you go.
Oh, okay.
Interesting.
I got my number 10.
What's your number 10, Ken?
It's an underrated movie. I love it. Sabrina, 1995.
I love Sabrina.
List. That's so good.
Julia Ormond.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Harrison Ford. Greg Kinnear. Directed by Sidney
Greg
Pollack.
Kinnear's first acting role.
Nuh-uh.
It is, because he was the host of Talk Soup. He's a comedian more and got cast in that. And then on dress rehearsals, he was chewing gum. And Harrison Ford was like,
who's chewing gum? And got mad at him, and it was a mess.
So
I love that movie.
That's a good impression. Great movie. Beautiful score. So, Mark, what's your top nine?
Nine is Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban.
Specifically that one.
Specifically
why? Because of the songs?
The songs, the orchestral arrangements that he did with some of the voices, Something Wicked This Way Comes. Yep, it's so good. Has the Harry Potter theme, goes a little darker. He gets. He really started to, and this was Williams' last Harry Potter score. Mm-hmm. He did three in a row, and this was his most dark and his most, I thought, mature, that was catching up with the kids' age, especially for a lot of people's favorite Harry Potter movies. So it's, yeah, it's become a score that I put in constantly.
I completely agree. It's a great score. Mm-hmm. And because number four was by Patrick Doyle, I believe, who also went dark and pretty cool.
Yeah, number four was Patrick Doyle, and then Nicholas Hooper did, five and six.
Yep.
Hooper.
And then, Desplat.
Five and six, and then Desplat did the two.
Seven. We're nerds.
Yeah, okay, so money out of your life, Hooper.
My top nine is actually Jurassic Park. I used to listen to that soundtrack over and over again when I was a kid. It's just perfect. It's a perfect, really cool action adventure score that gets almost to the point where it's too cheesy, but it's just the right amount of cheesiness, you know, for a Spielberg movie. So
that's good.
It's classic. What about you, John?
What's your number nine? Is E.T.
Good man.
Yeah.
Glad it made the top 10.
It made it, but it's I'm not always the biggest fan of the movie, but I do enjoy that score. That song is so iconic, and when you hear it, you can't help but be caught up in being remembering your childhood again. Mm-hmm. It just kind of hits all the right notes to bring you right back into being a kid again, and so I love it for that.
Okay.
I was debating between E.T. or what will be my choice, because I'm right with you, too, where I was at the right age where E.T. was one of the first movies I saw in a theater, and I was like, I think I want to kiss girls.
Yeah.
And E.T. made you think of kissing girls?
Yeah, the scene with the dissecting the
frog and everything, yeah. But I'll so I'm with you, too, where I hear it, and I'm just like, childhood, but I'll go with Superman, because the reason is I am not a superhero guy, but I grew up with that just in my brain, and so I'll put that a little lower for me personally, but I know it's higher probably in terms of what he did.
Yeah, I'm with you, man. I love that you put it on there. I mean,
Cody, any of those on the list?
I had no choice.
All right, we had E.T. was on there.
Oh,
Soroka got that one, nice. And then Superman with Ken.
Of course, nice. It has to be.
Okay, great. So what's your number eight, Mark?
My number eight is Catch Me If You Can.
It comes around.
It's pretty. I love it so much. It's so jazzy and perfect. It's really when I'm wanting to write some good, like, fun dialogue or just be upbeat, you put it on. Yeah. If you have a glass of wine listening to Catch Me If You Can, that's a good day happening right
there. Well, if you have a glass of wine on.
Just cross the board. You know, totally.
That makes everything better.
Everything.
So my number eight is the one of the most terrifying scores ever, which is Jaws. That's terrifying for me because I'm scared of sharks. Mark Reilly's obviously one of his favorite movies. This is one of the most genius things anybody's ever done, to have two notes literally be most of this score. Two notes that are in a minor key that scared the crap out of you, that alerts you that a monster is coming to get you. It's just brilliant.
That's as close as you get to the brown note, I think, is Jaws, the Jaws theme.
Agreed.
My number eight is Lincoln.
Ooh.
Lincoln.
I love his score for Lincoln.
Why?
Out of left field, Lincoln.
Because it just, you know, Lincoln is one of my favorite presidents ever, but what he does with that score in, like, evoking both the presidential nature of him, but also the way he was so unique to the presidency, because he's such an outlier as a president. And so when you hear the score, it's so, like, it's just so perfectly captures Lincoln that I thought, I love it. And I'm not the biggest fan of the movie, but that score is great, because you get that presidential vibe, but also that kind of exclusivity about it.
So, I agree. Yeah. It's almost like, this didn't make my list, but I think it's one of his underrated scores is The Patriot.
Yeah, Patriot's a good score.
Pretty
Patriot's
beautiful, great. Too. Yeah. Ken, what you got?
1982's Monsignor. I read the wrong. E.T. I'll throw E.T. there.
Okay. There it is.
Yeah. Very good.
Eight.
I'm eating one of John Rocco's peanut butter pretzels. Thank you. Offending Ken and Cody. Cody.
Time out. You did this in Chicago.
What?
I was watching Game of Thrones in my hotel room, and I demanded complete silence. And you went down to the bar and got the bar mix, and you crunched macaroons and nuts all through the episode. This is what you do.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
You crunch.
Well, did my crunching bother your Game of Thrones
experience? Complete silence. I don't want to hear you breathe.
Do you know Ken Napzok?
Damn.
Have you met him?
I was in there, and he seemed happy. I didn't realize he was pissed that I was consuming food because I was working all day, and
nice
I had
guy.
To eat a little bit. No.
But he has certain demands.
It's like people like, where are you going for the Super Bowl? Alone.
in my room.
Yeah.
I think that's why she calls everyone else fragile, because she likes to mess up everyone else's things by doing loud noises and making, you know.
I do love making loud noises.
So she's like, you're really fragile. I'm fine. You're fragile.
I didn't say I was fine. I am super fragile. I just admit it. Unlike the men in the room.
Shit, you can't argue with that.
So Jaws was one of them.
Jaws. Thank you, Cody.
Thank you, Cody.
And that was it.
Jess, okay. So no,
so
what is it? Lincoln.
No Lincoln, no. I mean, E.T. wasn't it, but he already.
Oh, yeah, we already went there. Okay.
So your number seven, Mark.
Is Hook.
Me too.
Nice. Is number seven?
Yes.
Nice, yeah. Hook is, you know, I know a lot of people, I love the movie. It's just, it kind of just hit me in that place when it came out. But the music is so beautiful. It's so, the flying theme for when Robin Williams, Peter Pan, finally realizes his happy thought and goes, that's one of the best themes of all time. The whole score is gorgeous, though. It really is. It's whimsical. You have the Hook theme as well.
It's just perfect for the movie.
It's perfect for the movie. It's one of his best. I love the score.
Talk about a score similar to a lot of the other stuff that John Williams does. This totally enhances the movie.
Yeah.
Like, this just makes the movie. It's a compliment to the movie. And it's interesting, too. I mean, I think, as you know, a lot everybody copies themselves and their own art. And obviously, I love Harry Potter, but the reason I didn't put it in here is because I think John took so many of the you know, the hooks and the melodic themes from Hook to put on Harry Potter.
Oh.
So
I would say for the first two movies, but listen to Prisoner of Azkaban again.
Yeah, I love it. I think it's great. Yeah. What's your number seven, John?
Schindler's List.
Yeah.
Very depressing, very beautiful, though.
Yeah, but I also think this is the first time John has composed an entire score without the lighthearted motiefs that he likes to slide in there.
Yeah.
Which is why it works so well with Spielberg.
Yeah.
I think both him and Spielberg like took this film seriously. They understood what they were, and they didn't want to make, like, even in Jaws, which has that doo-doo-doo, you still have, when they're on the boat, there you have that uplifting, like, we're on a mission here type of film. You get that thing and you're caught up in it. But in Schindler's, there's none of that. Even when the positive stuff happens, even when he's saving these people, there is still the melancholy hiding very, very firmly underneath all he's on the score. And so I think it's fantastic in that way.
It's really beautiful. And Itzhak Perlman played the violin in it. Yeah. And it's just, it's really, really
I remember
great.
When he did for the Oscars. When he did live for the Oscars, I cried.
Yeah,
that
violin hits and you're just like.
Well, and I at the Hollywood Bowl, when they have played it, when John Williams was there, I think it's, I forget who the violinist, the main, like the first chair violin plays it. I think it's Bing Wong. It's this woman that always plays either the Schindler's List theme or the Sabrina theme on the violin, and it's just amazing, and every time I cry. It's very annoying. Yeah. Ken, what did you got?
Number seven? Jurassic Park.
Perfect.
I don't like the movie. No, I do like it. I didn't see it in the theaters. I didn't really grow up with it in a sense.
Right.
But that sounds like if dinosaurs roamed the earth and you went to a park where they were hanging out, that'd be the sound playing.
Pretty much.
And I like that.
The epic nature of it.
Yeah.
Cody, did we win anything?
All right. Everyone's a winner. We
had
Hook mentioned.
Yes. Nice.
And we had Schindler's List, and then Jurassic Park was mentioned before.
You go. Nice. Okay.
Nice.
So what's your number five? Or no, it's number six.
It's Schindler's List for me.
Okay. Yeah. Mine is actually Sabrina.
Nice.
I think it's one of the most underrated things John Williams has done. It's a beautiful, beautiful theme. Also, mainly my violin, but it just keeps going. He keeps adding all these instrumentation to it. It's gorgeous. You guys should check it out if you haven't. John?
My number six is JFK.
Yes, that's so good.
That. Yes.
The trumpet.
That, all of it, the combo of it, just kind of gets me every single time. I was a mad addict to this film. It came out in the time when I was like an Oliver Stone junkie. And I went and saw this film like, I don't know, 10 times in the theater. I bought books and read up all the conspiracy theories.
Oh, yeah. I believe the movie was real. I was obsessed with that when I was a kid.
Right? And you're like, who's this Clay Bertrand? Clay Shaw? Yeah. Wait, how come no one's ever talked about it? You go searching and hunting for it and stuff. It was so fascinating to explore in the Warren Report, which I couldn't even finish, but like, it's a thing, but when you watch it every single time, and the movie doesn't 100% hold up nowadays,
But the score gives you the weight of what they're going after, and the sadness of the loss of this president is has, like, there are notes of that throughout his score, and this determination to like save America in his mind.
Yeah, so, it's pretty cool. You described that beautifully. Yeah.
I love your taste in music and the way you describe it, dude.
Listen, I bow down to you guys' knowledge of the school, but when
please, you're awesome, dude. That's awesome.
Ken, do you have a number six?
Number six, huh? How am I supposed to handle Star Wars stuff?
I think it's per movie.
Yeah. I'm doing per movie.
I think it's a score. Oh, wow. Score per movie. That's yes.
Tough.
It
That's
is.
It's tough for me.
That's why we're putting
a whole franchise.
I'm just going to put like one generic.
No, I only picked one Star Wars album. One Star Wars movie is what I picked.
I think it's your list. You can do what you want.
Okay.
That's true.
He does have the point.
So, number six. I'll go Saving Private Ryan at number six.
It's a pretty good one. So, Cody, did we make it?
Nothing new there.
That's right. It's not a
movie.
So JFK
is not on there. Is probably not on there.
No surprise.
Now we're going to do number five. Mark.
There's still three left.
Number five.
There's three left on his list.
I think we're going to get them. Okay.
We'll probably get there. Okay. My number five is Raiders of the Lost Ark.
That's a great one.
It's his for the Indiana Jones. If you want pure Indiana Jones, I have to give it to that, even though I think Last Crusade's really, really good because I love his theme for Sean Connery's, Henry Jones Sr.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. But Marion's theme from Raiders of the Lost Ark is one of the most beautiful, like, love themes.
Mm-hmm.
And then the action, of course. And if you put on the truck scene, that music.
Yeah.
You will get shit done in your place. You will clean.
You start cleaning.
You will clean. You will probably write a novel. You will probably do, like, so many things. That is the most fun, great action scene music that I play over and over and over again.
Right.
Yeah.
It's
so Raiders.
Good.
Raiders, baby.
It is very good. My number five, I know, is on Mark Riley's list and also has an incredible love theme. And that is Superman. Because not only is it one of the best, if not the best, superhero theme ever written, but the love theme, Can You Read My Mind, that is a good song, you guys.
Do you know the lyrics of that?
Can you read my mind?
Oh, God.
It's Melissa Manchester.
That's it?
I think.
I don't know lyrics in general.
Can you
read
my mind?
Yeah.
Do you know?
John, what do you got?
I guess I'd put I put Harry Potter, the whole series, but I guess I'll put whichever ones he did, but I'll put Prisoner of Azkaban. I'll put that one there, certainly, as my favorite of the entire one, so logically the score would be perfect there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Kent.
Number five?
Yes.
Gilligan's Island.
Did not know John Williams wrote that.
Johnny Williams.
Did he really?
Did all the music in the show.
There it
I'm a huge Gilligan's Island fan. I used to watch it four times a day during the summer on syndication. I love the show, and
he
got started in TV as Johnny Williams, and he did a lot of the music in that show. So I'm gonna put
that's pretty
cool.
Because
it's a childhood memory.
Yep.
Yeah, that's great. That's Cody, awesome. Anything in there?
Nothing new that time, guys.
Okay.
What?
Three movies left. No Gilligan's Island.
No Gilligan's Island.
Wow.
Okay, number four, Mark.
Jaws.
Great.
It's not as maybe some people might think it'd be like my number one, number two, maybe, but I put it here. Not even for the Jaws theme, though I love it. It's not what I go back to. It's the orca theme. The adventure the first barrel chase scene is one of the most beautifully composed, like, swashbuckling adventure.
That's
it's
perfect
so
word.
Perfect. It's like, it's this, when you watch Jaws, that action moment with the barrels and this music complementing it, it's just so fantastic. And then the last, very last track on that album is the orca theme again, but it's very slow, it's reserved, it's like, whew, we just killed a shark kind of thing. It's beautiful, too, and I
listen
to it all the time.
I mean, it's a beautiful moment for me because I was terrified of that shark as a kid.
Mm-hmm.
My number four is, I think, one of John Williams' most underrated scores, which is Close Encounters of the Third Kind.
I love it.
If it's not on that list, I think I need to have a talk with Adam Chitwood. I think
it should be.
It's amazing. When I was a kid, and it's crazy how many scenes in that movie are lacking dialogue, and it's all being told through the music, and it sounds like aliens are coming. Like that's exactly like John Williams did. He's a genius, man. That's why I blacked out when I met him.
Mm-hmm.
John, what you got for number four?
Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade.
And the Last Crusade,
because what you said about, the dad thing is so perfect. It kind of puts it over the top for me. And it's the one that I go back to and watch more than Raiders of the Lost Ark. So the score is one of the big reasons why.
It's my favorite Indiana Jones movie.
Yep.
Ken?
Excuse me, I'm adding more muted Star Wars words and phrases to my Twitter.
That's good.
I bet you don't have as many muted as I do.
As of today, I am no longer talking Star Wars online.
Same.
I have told people only on the shows I'm involved in.
I have told people to just check out the reviews that I'm in, and then that's it.
Yeah. No joke, I've muted, but one got through.
Yeah, there's
and
no
someone
talking.
Just spoiled something in a question to me.
Oh.
That I just like, you're monsters out there.
Yeah. It's ridiculous.
My number four will be Jaws.
Jaws, yeah.
Great one. Cody?
There was only one that time, and it was John Rocco with Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade.
Oh, they chose Last Crusade.
Okay. That's
interesting.
Really good. They're all really good.
Wow. Left.
Okay.
Not Kingdom of the Crystal Skull.
I feel you.
Okay. So since we're running out of time, let's go through the last three quickly. Mark, number three.
Superman. For obvious reasons, I love it, but there are tracks on that that are so gorgeous other than the Superman theme itself. The Leaving Home.
Krypton.
And Planet Krypton,
oof,
thank you. It's so beautiful. And, of course, then the Lois Lane flying theme. Can You Read My Mind? Beautiful.
My number three is my favorite Christmas soundtrack to listen to, which is Home Alone.
Home Alone. I almost.
So wow. Underrated.
It's so great.
That is a work of art, that album. John Williams did not just write amazing themes, but also songs, right? Somewhere in my memory, it's a super cheesy, beautiful song with a kids' choir that my mom makes us listen to every year. A beautiful soundtrack.
Mm-hmm.
Fair enough.
John?
Number three, Jaws. Three is Jaws.
Yeah.
Not just for the, like I said, the theme, the swashbuckling stuff, but also at the end.
Yeah.
That kind of like finale theme when they're paddling. Yeah, it's like we made it. We did it. We
really
survived.
Good.
Yeah.
Ken?
Three.
Hopeful. Yes.
Number three. That's going to be Raiders of the Lost Ark for me.
Okay.
Good man.
Yeah. I think the theme is just, come on, I'll hum that sometimes very badly because I can't sing in a car.
But you still feel like Indiana Jones when you hum it.
That's my favorite cinematic character.
Great.
Indiana Jones. And so I love it. Feels so adventure-y.
Is that a next book?
Cody?
Nope.
No.
Damn.
Keep going.
No Home Alone.
No. Nope.
I need to talk to Adam.
Two movies left.
Number two, Mark.
Empire Strikes Back.
That is also my number two.
That's your number two?
That's my number two as well.
No way.
Nice. Cross the board.
John,
yeah, Empire.
Not
my number two, no.
What's your number two?
Superman.
Oh, well, there you go.
Yeah.
So I picked Empire just because I think it has the biggest set of Star Wars themes that are my favorite. Yoda's theme. The Imperial March, I think, I'm going to make a bad joke now, but I think John Williams wrote that and then went to whatever girl he was dating or his wife, and I was like, I think we should have sex because I'm a genius.
Yeah,
that is
he
one of the coolest themes in a movie ever.
I mean, you look at him, you're like, that guy gets down to music.
For sure.
But the asteroid field chase is some of the best music ever. I love Han and Leia's theme was introduced in Empire Strikes Back. And still one of my favorite cues of all time in Star Wars, all time music, is when they're escaping on Bespin and R2-D2 does the smoke and that music surges and it's Yoda's theme of all things. Han and Leia's theme, Yoda's theme into Han and Leia's theme in different arrangements. It gets me every fucking time. And then, of course, the Battle of Hoth.
Right.
It's something some of the best music ever.
Agreed. Cody, anything?
Nope.
No Empire Strikes Back.
Still two movies left.
Okay.
Two movies.
What's our number one, Mark?
Number one is E.T. I've said
Me
everybody
too.
Knows it's E.T. Yeah. It's the most beautiful music from start to finish. I can listen to that entire album and every single song on there, every composition, all the way down to it, like an 8-minute track of them escaping with the E.T. that leads into flying, that leads into Elliot saying goodbye. On that cue of Elliot saying goodbye to E.T., I can quote it verbatim from memory based on the cue, and it makes me cry every time. E.T. is a fantastic score.
Yeah. Phone home, Elliot. Yeah, no, I agree. I think we all agree that it's amazing. What's your number one, John?
What's your number one, too?
Yeah.
E.T.?
Yeah, no, E.T. I think E.T. is
okay.
The reason I chose it is similar to what I said about Close Encounters, is that the music is basically a character itself in the movie, and all of the very sweet, magical moments between Elliot and E.T., there's not a lot of dialogue, right? It's just them discovering each other and like getting to know each other, and it's all of it's all John Williams' score. The emotional impact is mostly John in that movie.
Fair enough. It's Star Wars A New Hope. That's my number one.
Perfect.
Because, look, you get to see the full breadth of John's talent right off the bat. This is all the score. This is the entire orchestra.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And then the smaller stuff. The two sons moment. Yeah. He decorates that really softly. Mm-hmm. Then the Vader stuff, right? Then the Kenobi. Bum, 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 then the Kenobi death. And what does that mean? And then this guy. So all the image stuff to me.
The binary sunset.
The binary, yeah. All of it just throughout. I know Leia's theme's not in this, but like.
Yes, it is.
Yeah,
it
I
is.
Mean, Leia's, I'm sorry. It's not. Hana Leia's theme's not in this, but I think it's. He hits all the right notes with all these characters in this one. And this, it's I think this is the foundation for everything that comes up. Because you wait for that every single time. Every single movie, mm-hmm. Star Wars movie, you wait for that.
So, Ken?
Yeah, my number one. So Empire put number two. I think it might be his. But again, it's hard. It's always hard to. The first always gets erased sometimes.
Yeah, you know, you're it like, does. Yeah.
You forget it's the one that says. So I think New Hope's a great choice. Yes. Two, I put Empire just because, like, exactly what you said. Yoda's theme might be my favorite. I didn't realize it was one of my favorite themes until I really studied it. But I have to stand true to what I've said before. My favorite Star Wars score is Revenge of the Sith. Mm-hmm. And the reason is because John came in there and worked and just created some amazing stuff we'd never heard before in Star Wars. Phantom Menace brought the great rock single, but it starts with drums and war. It starts with this. And Padme's Rumination is one of my favorite songs, pieces in Star Wars. It's... And that was George telling a story with no words, and John's music told the story too. So it's weird to say, and you know, I'm prequels, you all know that, but like, Empire, New Hope, like Jedi, yub-nub me all life, yub all my nub. Life, man.
Lapty neck,
like it's crazy stuff, and I love a lot of new stuff too that he put out. The Rey's theme's one of my favorites. Blah blah blah. We had a discussion for a long time. I think Revenge of the Sith, he introduced some new stuff to me that I was like, wow, he threw a wrinkle in, and I love that.
Yeah, I mean, and as you know, I'm not a huge fan of the prequels. The music in the prequels is excellent, and I think you made a good point, Ken, that out of all the new Star Wars stuff that John has made, I think he definitely, for that particular movie, he did an excellent job with all of the character development and awesome looking planets. So, Cody. Do we win anything?
You got one of them.
What
we
get?
Did.
A New Hope.
Oh, there you go, John.
Well, Chetwood.
So okay. What did we miss? We missed one.
How about I reveal it in the final countdown here?
Let's do it.
All right.
I think we're done.
Coming in at number 10 was Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade.
Boom.
Wow.
Number 9 was Hook.
Boom.
Yeah.
Number 8, E.T.
Boom.
Too low.
7, Superman.
Boom. Mm-hmm.
Too low.
And number 6, this is the one you guys missed, Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone.
We're in the world. We're in the world.
Number 5, Schindler's List.
Boom.
Number 4, Catch Me If You Can.
Boom.
Number 3, Jaws.
Boom.
Number 2, Jurassic Park.
Boom.
Okay.
And number 1, A New Hope.
Keep doing it.
Boom.
God bless you.
Thank you for that, Cody. That was an excellent recap.
That's a good list.
Of Adam Chipwood's list.
That's a good list. Okay, I would move some things around.
I guess, do we have to put time to play a little game, or should we take some calls, Mark? I think we have time to play a little
game. Let's play the game.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, let's play the game. We're going to go to 3 instead of 5 this time.
Three?
So we can take some calls.
It might go quick. It might go,
exactly.
And then we can go to 5.
We did just analyze the crap out of John Williams.
You
so.
Two monsters, go 3. Go quick. All right, let's do it.
All right, so I'm playing the
You can
playlist,
just play
right?
at random. And do we, real quick,
we're gonna
clarification.
Say our names.
We say our names as our buzzer, but... Are we saying just like, because he has scores on there that from Empire Strikes Back, New Hope.
Are you asking if we're saying the name of the movie?
Yeah, I guess just the movie.
So you can't just yell Harry Potter if it's Harry Potter and the Wheelie Wibbles come get you.
Right, but I mean, I guess
that's
you can.
That's my favorite Harry Potter.
Yeah. Because it would be hard to, unless there's certain cues that he pulls that you can like definitely say, oh, that's Empire because of the asteroid chase.
I think you're analyzing it
too much,
Mark.
All right.
I think we should just play the game.
Why don't we just
see how seriously
I take
this?
Why are you making fun of these franchises, man? What's wrong with you? What's up?
I'm
going to start the game now.
I'm in a mood.
All right, Cody, start it up.
First one. Oh, shit.
Yeah.
That's Simple Plan.
I didn't know John Williams wrote for Simple Plan, Cody.
Yeah, it was
he's the drummer.
Career.
Yeah, there
weird.
Let's try this again.
Okay. Riley.
Torino.
Oh, Riley.
That is Revenge of the Sith.
That is correct.
That is correct.
Wow.
Great call.
Well done.
Jesus Christ.
Stand by. Hold on. Just these
this
are
is what
all...
I can't
all right. Hold on.
I can't.
Loading. This is awkward for all of us.
No, it's okay.
No, you're never awkward, Cody.
So I got to clip it at the end.
Multiple windows.
It's not like you're doing your job or anything.
Yeah, you're doing your job.
72 videos in here. You only have 72 windows open?
Yeah, 72 would be.
All right, here we go.
Shut up, Alex.
Darina. JFK.
No.
Damn it.
Mm-hmm. Ken.
You're waiting for
the Patriot.
No.
You got to wait for the trumpet.
Oh, I know what this is. Yeah.
Save Your Private Ryan.
Yep. That is correct.
Yeah.
was just going to do it.
It was a war.
It was.
Yeah. We were all on the same page.
You got to wait for the next. You always got to wait for the next instrument with him.
All right, here we go.
Dorina, it's Harry Potter.
Which one? Which
Sorcerer's Stone.
All right. Yeah, that's right.
Damn it.
All right, hold on.
Cody, you got this. Here we go. I believe in you.
Cat. Right. Hmm. Force Awakens.
That's correct.
Yeah.
Wow. Oh,
nice, Ken.
All right. Everything good? Everyone having a good day?
Yeah.
We are having a great day, Cody. Nobody's tired emotionally or anything.
Big breakfast.
This is getting me up. This is celebrating in the right way.
Big breakfast.
All right, here we go.
Yes.
Ooh.
I can't hear. I'm deaf.
Pedro Pascal is not in the costume. That's my name.
Also,
Riley.
What?
No, that was my name. I got it first. That was my name.
Oh.
It's Angela's Ashes. I don't know.
Damn. That was really good, though, Ken.
It is Jaws.
It is Jaws?
Nice.
Okay.
It is Jaws.
The score is 3 for Riley, Ken 1, and Dorina 1.
You want to keep going?
Alex, from the distant microphone.
Okay, let's go to 5 really quick.
All right, here we go.
Since we're almost.
She just wants to drive.
Riley.
No, I just want him to win.
Oh.
Do it, do it.
Raiders of the Lost Ark?
Nope.
Dorina!
It's either something else.
Last Crusade.
Nope.
Damn it. That's the other one.
Ken. Kingdom of the Crystal Skull.
Nope.
Oh.
Roka, Temple of Doom.
Oh, how'd you get that? Wow, that's impressive.
And you're on the board.
Great. Sometimes work, you just have to wait for them all fall.
Oh, yeah.
I was waiting for that curveball. I was waiting for that curveball, man.
Damn, oh, man. You went with Kingdom of the Crystal Skull.
That was the curveball.
That was a brave choice.
I would have said the same.
I know Cody Hall's sexy.
I know. That's why I thought that you might have won. Well done, Cody.
Nice. All right, here we go. We got another one.
Hey, Roka, good job. You're doing great.
Thank you, Alex. I'm still shaving that mustache off.
Here we go.
Cody.
Riley.
Oh, I heard my name.
I know. I was like, Cody, it's me. Cody, it's me. I mean, it's E.T.
Yeah,
we both know
it. Yeah, of course.
Right. I was like, Cody. I was like, I know it's E.T., but I don't know my name right now.
No,
so I'm saying Cody's name.
You got it, Cody. So.
Thanks, call me Cody from now on.
All right, here we go. Pulling up another one.
Roka, keep your head in the game. I believe in you.
Thank you, Alex.
Riley.
Oh.
Jurassic Park.
Good job.
Nope.
No.
Oh, Dorina.
Oh,
it's Fock. Nope. Empire.
Nope.
Damn it. It's the
Ken.
First one.
Oh, right. I can't believe it.
A New Hope.
Yeah, it is. It is. That's what I meant.
No,
sorry.
It's not.
Good job. Oh, cool.
Your time to shine, buddy.
Yeah.
Roka, come on. You got this.
Feels like Return of the Jedi.
Nope. I can fast forward a little bit here. Hold on.
Okay, go forward.
Revenge of the Sith?
It's Last Jedi.
It's one of the new ones. Yeah, that's why I don't know it.
I thought the Force Horns was the womp, womp, womp.
Yeah.
I thought it was a New Hope,
like,
and then it's an Empire. Good job tricking us, Cody.
Yeah, I really got you guys.
Yeah, you did.
Really did.
Give me a second. There's like 87 Star Wars ones.
John Williams has written a bunch of music or anything, making this game hard for you.
He's also done other movies that aren't franchises. You could just
play Sabrina or Munich.
What about Just the Tip?
Catch Me If You Can.
Here we go.
You say Just the Tip?
This is Dorina. This is also Star Wars.
Yeah.
No, it's not.
Oh.
And
I don't
know.
Oh, I know what this is.
Hold on.
Ken. Close Encounters of the Third Kind?
No.
I can't pull it.
Sound like aliens.
Roka, AI?
Nope.
Oh.
Keep Riley, going. You still in it?
Yeah. Trying to pull it. Riley, Hook.
It is.
Damn!
I was wrong. I was going War of the Worlds.
Had to get there.
Well done. Did you get 5 already?
That's 4.
You got like 7.
4.
You got like 7.
Yeah, are we done?
Load them.
Should we take some calls?
You want to take some calls?
Let's take some calls. Good job, Riley.
Good job, Riley.
Thank you.
Let's take some calls, Cody. Right. Thank you for playing along. We are huge John Williams nerds, except for Roka.
No, that's why you don't give him scores and soundtracks at a match.
You found that out the hard way.
Are you not good
at
those?
Aww.
But do they clip out actual songs
for
you guys?
No, they just give you.
We tried to do that. We wanted to do
that
at one point.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, Cody, please let us know, maybe via Meow, maybe via Star Wars rant, whatever you would like when somebody's on the line. Are you also emotionally exhausted this weekend, as all of us?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Very tired.
Yes.
Like,
yes.
like, should we just do something else? Should we just quit?
Trying to do something else. I'm in the middle of working on a big project that will hopefully take me away from a lot of this.
Can you not? Can you not talk about it?
Cannot talk about
it. Okay. Well, I wish you the best of luck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. I think we should just do a music podcast.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm launching a baseball feed, baseball podcast too. Force Center always going to exist. As long as I'll have my Jedi Council, always exist. It's not just Star Wars. It's not just Star Wars.
No, it's not.
It's this industry.
Yeah, it's all of it.
Yeah.
Yes. Oh, I'm with you, man.
Yeah, let's develop some inside jokes. I want to know you, man. Want to make you smile. Want to be your sunshine.
Does that mean we have a call code?
Yes, we do.
Okay. Holy well, fire. You are on Collider Live. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
My name's Bobby Lombardi, but all my friends call me Belt Buckle Bobby. But you guys can call me Belt Buckle. I'm from Glenwood Springs, Colorado.
Wow. Belt Buckle. I love this.
Great intro. What have you got for us today?
I just want to call in. I've been trying to get in forever, and I'm not always able to call in because I'm busy working. But
you're in now.
Landscaping or ranching.
Nice.
I'm in. I love movies. I love listening to you guys. I don't have a lot of nerdy friends that are into movies, so it's great listening to you guys. I just went through some things, losing my dad about 10 months ago.
That's tough. Just
hearing Roxy and Christian and Roca's stuff has really helped me get through what I needed to get through, and just having that positive outlook and still getting through life. So I love you guys, and just wanted to share that.
That's so sweet.
Appreciate that, dude.
That's so sweet.
Really appreciate
respect
you saying
Bell
that.
Respect Belt Buckle.
Do you have a question
yeah,
for
Buckle
us?
Belt Buckle Bobby, triple B.
Triple B.
So, what a great attitude. Do you have a question for us? You just wanted to chat?
I've had so many questions for you guys, but I don't have one right now. I'm sorry.
No, you're good.
But I did fall asleep to Raiders of the Lost Ark last night, and then I went to work on my graveyard, so that was good.
Mm. Oh, your graveyard? What were you doing on your graveyard?
Graveyard shift.
Okay.
I work at I make snow up valley, so I start at midnight to noon.
I did the graveyard shift for 2 years, bro. It ain't easy, so respect. Also, it's the holidays, man. Sending you mad love as you deal with this during the holidays, brother. Yeah. Take it one step at a time, man.
Thank you so much
thank
for
you guys,
the call.
And I'm looking forward to Last Jedi, so love you guys.
I love that.
Okay.
I think you meant Rise of Skywalker, right?
Yeah. I'm not going to correct Bell Buckle.
No,
or
I'm
maybe,
not
or maybe
him.
He hasn't seen Last Jedi, and he's just going to see it for the first time. So
I think
hope
if
he
wants to see The Last Jedi, I think that's a good thing.
Yeah. Okay, Cody, please let us know we have somebody
else
on the
call. Let's take a day trip to Santa Barbara, me and you. Let's hit up some charming shops. Let's buy some antiques.
You are on Collider Live. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
That's soundbite.
Sounds like Alex.
Hey.
Hello.
How you doing?
How are you doing? What's your name?
I'm fine. This is Calvin.
Calvin's back.
Calvin with a sexy voice.
What's up, dude?
I remember Calvin.
How you doing, Calvin?
Yeah, what's up, Calvin?
What's going on, kid? I still haven't been to that Cheddar's.
Why haven't you gone to that Cheddar's?
I will make it down there.
Johnson City, Tennessee Cheddar's is a home away from home.
Yeah.
And you need to get over there right now. And do it. It's not too far from Kingsport. You can fly in if you need airport access. Get over there.
I love, and I want to tell everybody else too. It's good. It's a good country over there.
It's very
good
nice people.
Country.
Very nice people.
Do you have a question for us today, Calvin?
East Tennessee. No, but Dorina, you are amazing. I like your shirt today.
You're amazing. I'm glad you like good music. I love King Gizzard.
Yeah, I wrote here in y'all's rankings of the scores, and I liked Raleigh's pull on that hook. That was magnificent.
Thank you.
But I just wanted to call in and say what's up to Ken. I don't really have a question. I just want to tell Ken what's up. I rarely get to talk to him anymore.
Yeah,
but
by design. But good to not for you, Calvin. I love you. I used to love when you call into Schmo's East Tennessee State Buccaneers, right out there. Great spot. Great spot.
All right.
Oh, thank you for calling, Calvin. Always nice to hear your awesome voice.
Calvin's the best.
Yeah, he's
so
that
just he's just he seems like he's just like.
He's just chill.
How you doing?
He's just happy just to be here.
Yep.
Yeah, exactly. Cody, please let us know when there's
you, you're from that area.
Hold each other.
Have you gone to Cheddar's?
And then,
no.
Eat. okay with the silence and like not feel necessary.
Okay.
Which is like listen to what our bodies.
Like you were
going
to take me to Sizzlers? No. I'm not going to hold my breath. I
mean, you guys are talking through these great sound bites.
You guys are missing Cody's genius sound bites here. You guys.
Yeah. I've heard that sound bite.
Like, what are you pulling?
You are on Collider Live. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Oh, I'm so excited I got through. It's Troy from Boston.
What's your name?
Troy.
Hey,
Troy.
Hey, Troy, how are you?
Good, thanks. Or Riley and Cody might know me as the Merlot line on Discord.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, all right, man. How are you?
How you doing? Do you have a question for us today?
I have five questions.
Oh. Five?
Last time I got through was Karloff's second to last day. We played soundbite trivia. I was hoping you might want to play again.
I mean, jeez.
I mean, we got about 10 minutes left.
You
on
got
the
one?
Show, so
did you say movie trivia?
How about we pick one question?
Is it movie trivia?
Sure.
What'd you say?
Yeah, it's movie trivia. I got five categories.
Five
categories. I got the category of Makuga, Riley, The Wangers, Callers, or Collider Live Guest.
Okay.
Okay, let's we just pick one?
Yeah, let's.
I'm going to pick Wangers.
Okay.
I'm going with the Wangers question. Okay. Subcategory is classics. This is a tough one. As of its release in 1959, this epic drama was the most expensive film ever produced and features the largest set ever created, used for its famous chariot race scene.
Ben-Hur.
Ben-Hur is correct.
Yeah.
No, I thought he hung up on you because you won his game. Yeah. Oh, well,
till the
good
till
job,
they got
John.
to the chariot race, I thought it was Cleopatra.
It's gonna go, yeah.
Yeah.
What's the one that DeMille? Is that Ben-Hur?
Ten Commandments.
Shout it out in Guadalupe, where I live.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm.
But if I can throw you one more, I think you'll love the Riley question.
Okay, let's do it.
Just give me the Riley
let's
question.
Let's do it, Troy.
In honor of tonight, Star Wars related question. I'm pretty excited to see it myself. But this historical character has been portrayed by Star Wars veteran Max von Sydow, Ewan McGregor, and Liam Neeson, notably in his film debut.
It's a historical figure.
Oh.
Ewan McGregor, Max von Sydow, and Liam Neeson?
It's like something Collins.
Michael Collins? No.
No?
Because it wasn't.
Come on, Riley, get mad. You can get this one. Get angry.
Get angry. Yeah, I'm trying to think. Ewan McGregor.
Jesus.
Yeah.
It's not Sir Gawain. That's who he was in Excalibur.
I don't know. Maybe
I'm trying to go through his.
You got a hint for us, Troy?
Remember, it's a soundbite. It's a Collider Live soundbite. It's already been played today.
Oh.
Jesus.
Cody, do you know it?
Jesus.
Where's no. That?
No.
It's not that.
I have no
it's
idea.
It's a soundbite.
Jesus.
Oh, it is correct.
It's Jesus.
Guys. He played. Yeah.
It's Jesus.
I don't get it.
I was trying to tell
it's,
you.
Yeah, thank you. You were,
Jesus.
Cody.
Okay.
When I blew it.
When did Liam play
I don't
Jesus?
Know.
What film was that?
I remember Ewan. I don't remember Liam Neeson or Max von Sydow.
Mm. I don't know.
Yeah, good questions,
okay.
Though, dude. I appreciate
it. First film. I can't remember to be honest. I wrote these questions like a month ago, two months ago, but okay. It was one first film.
Well, we appreciate it, Troy. Thanks, Troy, for the call.
Thank you for the call, dude.
Cody, let us know. We probably have time for a couple of more calls.
Yeah.
Ken.
Yeah.
Where can people find you at Jedi Council? If you would like to plug your show that you're so very good on.
Where can they find it?
Yeah. No, what time? What's
what time?
Going on?
It's
like
coming today.
I think we're still doing it where it's released at 5. Eventually, the plan was to go live. But today is just a general show with a little bit of non-spoiler. And then next week is our in-depth discussion.
Like
on
spoiler
on
discussion.
Gigantic spoiler
yeah,
discussion.
So that one comes next week for Christmas week.
Okay.
Perfect.
Because we're not going to be here.
That's correct.
And you're going out of town, aren't you?
Going to Prescott.
Prescott.
Is that North Dakota?
Arizona.
Wish. Arizona.
Arizona.
Okay.
I'm like, looking up where he was.
Meaningful compliments.
Oh, looks like we got a caller. Yes. Caller, you're on Collider Live. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Oh, my gosh, guys. I am so excited today. It's Star Wars Day. My call got through. I've been playing Battlefront 2 all day. It's an amazing day. Thank you guys for taking my call. I'm so excited.
Yes.
Yay. What's your name?
My name is Court. I'm from Virginia.
Hey, Court.
Court? Shout out, Virginia. Respect, man. That's where I'm from.
I love the enthusiasm.
Actually,
hell yeah. Enjoy your
I'm
day,
very
dude.
Excited
enjoy
for
Star
you.
Wars.
I hope you like the
it's
movie.
Been awesome.
Do you have a question for us?
I do, and this is so stupid. It has nothing to do with Star Wars. Is that okay?
That's
of course.
Perfect.
Please.
Perfect. All right, so you guys have Roka in the room, and I'm excited.
Uh-oh.
Because I think it was earlier this week. Roka, you had a great take on Richard Jewell, where he would like, I don't want to paraphrase, and maybe you can clarify where I'm wrong, but it was like, you were kind of frustrated that people were judging it before they went in because of their political beliefs or where they thought it was going to stand. I thought it was a really good way to kind of watch that movie. You know, I think you set it up really, really well. It made me want, I haven't seen the movie yet, but I want to see it. I really liked your take on it. So with that, what is a movie that does handle politics, you know, that you guys think it actually handled it really well? What's a movie that really handles politics in a really great way?
Okay. Good, difficult question. Thank you for
Team
the call.
America.
Definitely agree with Ken Napzok. I think Ken has the most genius, brilliant answer. Team America is fantastic. That final speech.
That's my political aesthetic.
Completely agree.
I like that.
The speech about assholes and pussies and all of it. Yes.
I mean, those are the words I wouldn't use, but yes.
Yes.
You're going to say
Mr. Smith goes to Washington.
Yeah.
I think that's the one that's incredible, for the idealism versus the reality of politics.
Right.
And what can, and how they can smash together and who will win in the long run. It's fantastic.
What year was that?
1939.
That's a long time, too, yeah. Mm-hmm. Jimmy Stewart, right?
Mm-hmm. Jimmy Stewart, Claude Rains.
Yeah. I was
Gene Arthur.
We had to study that in school.
Really?
Yeah, like economics.
It wasn't a chore for me.
Not economics.
Good. Economics.
What's the other version? One semester you get economics, the other one you get like
government.
Government.
Yeah,
really? You guys had a government class?
Yeah.
Huh.
Well, I'd love to see Cody in government class.
Okay.
Got a B+, John.
Good job.
Social studies might have been it.
That's what I had in Spanish, yeah. Ciencias sociales.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's what I studied in high school.
Mm-hmm.
Those are both great answers. I still agree with Team America, though. Mark, Cody, Alex, anybody has an answer?
I sure don't.
I mean, like, I think of All the President's Men as interesting from just the investigative journalist side because of, like, what they're trying to get through.
Right.
They have to deal with the politics on the outside.
What about Primary Colors?
I was thinking Primary Colors as well.
Yeah.
I found that interesting. American President.
Yeah, there you go.
American President is just it's a good romantic comedy.
It's pretty good.
Just set in the White House.
I mean, if you guys are talking about
no politics,
like
really,
sort of politics, but more of a journalist movie, Spotlight, I think is a fantastic movie that handles that type of movie. Usually goes very Hollywood-esque, and I think they did a really good job by making it more realistic. And obviously, Michael Keaton's in it, so you know.
Yeah,
you love
Ken. Him. You were gonna say something.
Love Actually.
The best Love politics it. Movie there is for Christmas. Yes.
Yeah. Hugh Grant.
Definitely.
Hugh Grant
is That's how you talk to the American president, let me tell you.
That's a good scene, too.
Make him dance.
Who plays the president?
Okay.
Billy Bob Thornton.
Isn't he perfect?
I thought it was John Cena.
Anyway.
I was
Cody.
Trying to cue him up.
Yeah. We got time for one more call, I think, Cody.
You in Diamond Bar? You want to stop by? Stop by, man.
You're going to have to tell us what this is. Caller, you're on the line. You're on Collider Live. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hey, it's Parker from Virginia.
Hey, Parker.
Hey, Parker.
Virginia callers today.
Nice.
How are you today? What do you got for us?
I'm not bad. I'm seeing Rise of Skywalker tonight. And you know what? I was going to ask you guys a Star Wars question, but you know what? Fuck it. It's going to be a hell weekend, so screw it.
You ask whatever you want.
You can ask it. I mean, hey, man.
Ask whatever you want,
positive.
Parker.
He's strapping in.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm strapping it. So I was trying to come up with a question while I was waiting to get on the line, and this is the only thing I could come up with. Tell me a food poisoning story.
Oof. Okay. We're going to get into it. Thank you for the call, Parker.
I'm back interested into the show.
This is where Ken shines. Please, Ken. Please.
I went to the Largo.
Oh,
the old Largo. I saw David Bazan, I believe, from Page of the Lion, and he was doing solo stuff, and Bick Runga, me and my friend
Bick
Jeff.
Bick Runga.
Great. We're great night. I get the chicken parmesan. Great. Next morning, I wake up, shit my pants twice. And I had to miss work, but that night I was set to be executive protection for Minnie Driver. And I really wanted to do that. I had to. My boss was like upset. Why aren't you in here? And I finally had to tell her, I pooped my trousers as I was leaving. To get in my car, and she was like, "That's okay. Don't come in. We'll see you later." And I cleaned up, and Minnie Driver's none the wiser. But it was bad.
Yeah,
I'd never experienced it, John. Mm-hmm.
What do you mean? What do you mean by bad? Was it the
food
actual
poisoning?
No, it's I know, worst. But was that the only time you got in food poisoning, or the worst?
It's the only time.
Oh.
Like I thought it was a myth. I was like, who are these people that eat bad chicken? And
and
9 barfs in a do. You're like, whoa, this is killing me. I think I'm dying. And then my last memory was Bick Runga singing, you know, like from the song from American Pie. Oh, yeah. And I'm just
like,
it was a mess.
Yeah.
A mess.
Literally.
God.
Literally.
The worst.
Yeah, the messiest bathroom experience you ever had.
Well, we're not talking about the rest stop in Arizona where the Flagstaff. That wasn't my problem. Okay. But a urinal is not a toilet.
Oh, God.
Okay. Well, thank you for that, Ken. Mark, Cody, Alex, John, do you have any other very descriptive food poisoning stories?
There's like four of them. I don't know which one.
You all know my chili story, but that's not really food poisoning. That was them literally trying to kill me.
Yeah.
Through poison that opened up some stomach issues for me. That it wasn't like that, like having that. Thank you, Cody. It was more like stomach aches for months. Yeah. But there's one I have where I was driving. I ate something. I don't know what it was. And then I got on the road to drive from San Francisco down to L.A., Orange County.
Don't do that.
And I was like, oh, God, pull over.
Oh, yeah.
And I threw up.
Yeah.
And then I got back in. I'm like, oh, that was weird. And then pull over. So it started coming out. And then, unfortunately, on one of those long roads where there's nothing, I said, pull over again. Yeah. And it was the other end.
Yep.
Ooh.
On the side of the motherfucking road. At least it was the worst.
You got to go.
Only the cows were watching.
Yeah.
I remember Wendy's came out with some new sandwich with mushrooms.
Oh, Jesus.
And I went to go get
Wendy's sandwich. Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
With the mushrooms.
Of course you do.
Yeah. And then I had it.
Yeah.
And within 2 or 3 hours,
oh no!
I was just Armageddon inside
I just
my
pooped
stomach.
My pants.
It was Armageddon in there, man. Just Armageddon. I don't mean drilling for oil. I just mean like
you don't mean a Diane Warren song.
No, I don't. I don't.
He did want to miss all the things in this case.
It's the worst because I have a proclivity to go more than usual anyway. So that would just like open it all up.
Is that documented?
Yeah, four times a day. I go four times
documented
a day.
Documented? Mm-hmm. I want a doctor's note from you.
Okay, my GI says it's normal.
Wow.
You're supposed to go right after you eat every single time. That's normal.
Okay. Well, clearly we're all abnormal here.
Oh, you're not at my age. Wait till you get to my age.
No, exactly. But I'm already almost there. But that's unfortunately all the time we have for today. As much as we'd like to continue talking about food poisoning, I want to thank Christian Rubalcaba for joining us earlier, Ken Napzok for joining us later. Always a pleasure to have him. Cody, Alex in the booth, Mark Riley, John Rocha. We will be back tomorrow. Forrest Galante is going to be here. We're going to interview him. I'm excited for that. And Perry Nemirov will be joining us. Love you guys. Have a happy Thursday. Enjoy whatever movie you're watching tonight. See you tomorrow.
Hey, man. I got you an orchid, baby.